Greetings, Lunarians. Welcome back to the Empire. I'm your host, Valkosunari, here with my good friend and fellow streamer, Dragonwelp. Say hello, brother.
What's up, man?
He's here in full force, man. We're ready to play, man. So, before we begin, real quick, Dragonwelp, would you like to do some introductions about your channel, bro?
No, I don't do shameless plugs.
No shameless plugs? Okay, I'll plug you later.
Well, then, hey, you're more than welcome to plug me, but I don't plug my own channels and anything like that.
Got you. Well, let's start with this one then. So all of his links are in the description below, his YouTube, his Twitch, and his Mixer, whatever you fancy. Please go ahead and join that up and show him some love. All right.
Oh, thank you.
No problem, man. No problem. We show the support. All right. So what we're going to be doing today is some Stellaris. I have no clue how long we're going to be playing for. Quite a while, I'd say. Could go upwards of 6 hours. We don't even know. But so let's go ahead and start a new game with the multiplayer here. I will go ahead and host. All right. So password is the same as yesterday. Do you recall?
I do recall.
All right. Let's see. Let me go ahead and bring this up. Server name is gonna just be Valkos and Dragon.
Okay.
Like it was last time.
Okay.
And boom. All right, no caps on the password.
Roger that.
Let's see. World of Final Fantasy, how you doing, man? Good to see you in the stream. Welcome. Congratulations on your 100 nobles, man. That's that took me a long time to actually get that for the first time. It was tough. So, yeah. It's a high ambition trying to platinum that. All right. Do you see the game? There you are.
Yep.
All right.
I am here.
Woohoo! Awesome. We are ready to go. Sort of. We need to select empires.
Indeed.
I don't know who I want to be.
Do you want to do empires that complement each other, or do you want to do like same? I don't know. It doesn't matter to me either way.
It would be nice to do a compliment, yeah. Just because.
Okay.
Just to be different, I guess.
Oh yeah, for sure.
And if we can, I would like to actually set it to where we know where each other are on the map, like right off the bat.
That's perfectly fine.
But if not, you can just tell me, and then we'll try to meet up. Let's see. I don't really have a preference. What kind of style do you want to do? Do you want to do like passive, or do you want to be like militaristic?
I don't know. I mean, like I said, I've only played this like on stream once.
Yeah.
Or twice.
Yeah.
So it's something that I'm still learning about this game. So I was hopefully not only is this like a game that we co-op together, but it's also something that we like you teach me a little bit, because this game is fascinating. I want to learn more.
Yeah, it's insanely fascinating. You'll start over several times on single player. So hopefully we can keep this one going and not die. But like we have to make sure that we do not neglect military, but we don't necessarily have to go that route.
Right.
So I think like the best way to learn the game maybe is to be sort of passive and maybe focus on research and defenses for military, basically. So, the United Nations of Earth is well-rounded. Like if you hover over all of these passives, you'll see the tooltips. Border friction is -25%, which means that they do not like encourage war as easy. So, let's see. Baku, thanks for the host, man. Where you at? You lurking, man. Odai, what's up, brother? How you doing? Dragonwelp's in here, man. Say hello. Let's see. Fnatic. Faction influence gain +50%, consumer goods cost. So really the only drawback with the humans is that they consume their goods quicker than others.
Right.
Which isn't terrible, really. So it's a decent start. So there's two different human races or human factions. There's the United Nations of Earth and the Commonwealth of Man. Let's see. Democracy holds an election every 10 years. Commonwealth, dictatorial... holds an election upon ruler death is selected ruler. Okay, well, whatever. What's the biggest difference between the two?
One is military based, it seems.
Yeah, that's what it seems as well.
Yep.
Okay. I think I'll just go with the United Nations of Earth, just the very first one.
Okay.
And these guys are good with just like with diplomatic influence, so we can like really benefit from each other very quickly, or quicker than others could, provided we can find each other pretty quickly.
Yes.
Unity is good. Citizen Pop happiness, so happiness isn't a problem, so people will continue to produce the best resources. Habitability is good, so you colonize faster. Migration speed is good. Resettlement cost is great. okay, cool. So I know that the Skildari are pretty passive as well.
Yes, they are. They are the Zen people.
They are. They're like the monk mole rats or whatever they are. I don't know what they are called.
Basically, so, yeah.
Yeah, the Dokkum. That's what the race is called. Interesting. All right. Let's see. Yeah, Baku's lurking. Event? What? What event? So heads up, there's a Warframe event. Last till tomorrow. Okay, I'm definitely going to have to jump on that later tonight. Let's see.
If you go the United Nation of Earth, I will more than happy go with the Skildari because I've played them before.
Yeah, so it'll be a quick start for you as well. So. Right. All right, I think it's decided.
There we go.
Cool. All right, as far as the settings on the right, let's see. To keep it like sort of normal, let's go ahead and just stick with medium. Seems pretty good. The galaxy shape isn't really that important, honestly. It's just kind of whatever your preference is. The ring, the center is not accessible.
Right.
So do you have a preference on galaxy shape?
I have no preference whatsoever, sir.
Okay. How about... See, if there is indeed a possibility we can link up quickly with a ring galaxy, then it's not going to be as difficult to contend with other empires.
Right. I'm gonna laugh. You get at the north end, I get on the south end, and we're just like, oh no, there's a person between us.
Exactly, no! Exactly. So it could happen, but to be safer about it, maybe elliptical would be good. Spiral's kind of risky. Let's see.
Yeah, spiral is risky.
Yeah. Sure. How about we go elliptical?
Works for me.
Just so we don't have to fold with the center in case we're that separated. So, all right. For the AI empires, any preferences here? I would say maybe like 6 to 8.
6 to 5. That's fine with me.
Okay. Let's go 6. Advanced AI starts. I don't want any advancement for their starts. We're supposed to be even. Let's see. And the regular AI empires will start with an initial advantage in resources. Nope, that goes to 0. All right, straight to 0. Max fallen empires. I don't want to play with any fallen empires because they are very difficult to contend with if you run into them.
Right.
So not for the first playthrough. Tech tradition cost and blah. That's fine. Ratio's fine. Start year. Here. Okay, difficulty. So, Grand Admiral, we should go for that, right?
Sure, why not?
We want to get killed right away.
Yeah.
Monk rats, yes, that's what they're called. Monk rats. Darkness, what's up, buddy? How you doing? So.
Skildari are monk rats? I always thought of them as sloth type creatures.
Either that's or, still, I guess.
Maybe it works.
Yep. Advanced neighbors know. AI aggressiveness normal. Empire placement. Clusters, random. Let's go clusters. Why not? It's fine.
Okay.
That looks good. Any other preferences, man?
Nah, dude. It looks good to me.
Boom. All right. Let's ready up.
Readying up.
And start. We have begun.
Yes.
It's exciting, man. I have never co-op this game with anybody, so this is gonna be a joy. Joining darkness on that one. What is the REEEEE thing going on here?
Yeah, exactly.
I think they're making the Skildari sounds or trying to do that or whatever.
I don't know.
That's funny. All right. Begin. All right. So, if anybody has any questions about the game, please let us know. We will be happy to answer them. This is not a tutorial. This is just a chill stream. We're going to have some fun. Yep. And, yeah. So... We will say, though, that we can pause and unpause the game whenever we feel like it.
Indeed.
So I think we should just keep it paused maybe and set up, and then we can go ahead and branch off.
That's up to you, dude. It doesn't matter to me. I'll leave you with the ultimate pause and
okay.
controls.
Yeah. If you need to pause, like, at any point in time, go right ahead because it doesn't matter to me. It's right. not going to matter too much anyway, just because, you know, it's mostly all management here. You can still manage right. while you're within, you know, the pause menu. Okay, first of all, I need to know where you are.
Okay, so if you look on the map and you see Abanus, I think I'm pronouncing that right, the Abanus Nebula.
Yes.
I'm right literally on smack on top of the Abanus Nebula.
I'm right smack below you.
Oh, really?
Yes, I'm right below that. All right, I'm coming north.
I'm coming south. Let's do this.
That's funny.
Because so, if we can get our borders to line up, then there's no chance for a player faction or AI faction to come in between us.
Yeah. So your empire is started on the nebula.
Yeah.
Wow. Okay. Yeah. Science is on its way. Let's see. Right click, survey. The fleet, like your first fleet, is good for exploring as well. If you want to like go in two different directions, or we can just try to meet up as soon as possible.
Well, that's that. Like, I'm just going to let the game progress as it goes. If it happens that way, it happens that way. Because
okay, all right. Let's see. How about we do this? Let's take our military fleet that we start with, and try to meet up like that really quick. And then we can go in opposite directions because I'm kind of like closed off here a little bit. So, yeah. All right. I'm going to head up to, let's see. Actually, I can't, can I? You have to survey it first, don't you?
Yes, you do.
Huh. Yeah. But, the master's forgetting stuff.
You can send your survey ship, your science ship, as far as you want.
That's right. That's right. You are correct on that. Alrighty. Goes to show how much I know. All right, yeah, you can go ahead and unpause it. I need to refresh something here, so I'm good to go.
Okay.
Viewer count is incorrect. That is so dumb. I have to refresh that every time.
But what I did is I put my my science ship as far to the south of me, and I had them to survey that area. And I'm also building a new spaceship or a science ship, so that way we can get this going.
Yeah, I think I will also build a new science ship. No, it's not there. Let's see. Spaceport. Science. Costs 100. I have 200. Yeah, sure. Why not? The only issue with that is that we have to make sure that we have an additional scientist.
Yes.
So, do I have an additional scientist is the question. Where is that done? Let's see, technology, more leaders. Recruit. Okay. Man, that costs 100 energy. That's all my energy. That's unfortunate. It's not terrible. It is his passive, though, leader recruitment cost. But the leader is young, so he'll last quite a long time.
Right.
Darkness, I'll see you later, man. Take care. Let's see.
Bye, darkness. So long, darkness, my old friend.
I was going to start singing it. It's like, usually we say hello to darkness, but now we're saying goodbye. All right. So he's available. Good. All right. I think that's fine. Cool. Can I do any construction? I can do research stations. Actually, wait, pause. Because we need to queue up research, too.
I've already done that.
Okay, good. I have not. You are ahead of me, my friend. You want to take over? No.
You can teach me a lot more than I know already. I just I'm so used to playing games like RTS games like StarCraft. Mm-hmm. You have to just be on the ball. There's no pause button.
Yeah. So. Dawn of War?
You Dawn of War fan? No. Just old StarCraft stuff.
Ah, gotcha. Man. I love the Dawn of War series. It was so much fun. Let's see. Energy, storage capacity, no. Physics lab, fusion reactor. Oh, man. Power plant. That might be useful to get more power overall. Sure. We'll do that. Population growth speed. That is probably the best. Let's see. Should I? Yes, do that. And this will be, let's see. Army and minerals. Cold gun engineer. Army damage and minerals. Absolutely. All right. Turns could take a while in this, just so you know, everybody.
Oh, yeah. That
depends on, like, when, what our scale of micromanagement is later on.
Oh, my micromanagement, I can micromanage pretty quickly.
Yeah, same here. Just I like to, you know, double check a lot of stuff.
Oh, indeed, indeed. Double, triple, quadruple check.
Absolutely. Oh yeah, Odoi, Dawn of War was great. I think I still like the first one the best. I have the third one. I haven't beaten it, but like, I started to record episodes of it. It's just, it's so much like a MOBA now, sort of, with the leaders. Like, the way they move and interact and stuff like that, it feels like you're controlling like a MOBA champion. But I don't know. I'm not sure how I feel about it yet. Spaceport of Earth has finished its construction queue. Very good. All right. Let's see. I need 180 for the mining stations. That is important. Let's see. Earth.
I need 200 to recruit a science leader.
Okay.
Hurrah.
Speaking of science ship, it's done. That's good.
Situation log updated.
Is it done? Wait. Yeah, it's done. Okay. So I can add you. And then I can go to different directions here. So let's just branch off this way. Actually, no. You're going to go this route. Now you're going to go up there. That's right. Science needs to go meet up with you. So survey that. Excellent.
Excellent.
Excellent. At some point, I wasn't allowed to play as Necrons when I played against friends. Are you serious? Mm-hmm. Just because it was too powerful? That makes sense. Man, when you read the lore behind Necrons, it's ridiculous. It's like, these guys just never go away. Doesn't matter what you do. Let's see. I forget the year of that, when that first came out.
Awesome.
Long time ago.
Warping in players. A galaxy far away.
Boo was under an attack.
I thought me and Qui-Gon Jinn could talk the Federation into... Okay.
We came to hear Dragon Well break out in song, everyone.
It's so please fun continue. To do.
It's a chill stream. Why not? You might as well.
Why not?
I can provide some accompaniment, maybe.
I'll start breaking out into a song that nobody's ever heard of, and they're like, wait, what?
Hey, that's a nice plug for the artist, I suppose.
True.
And people are like, very, very what's that song? I'm going to go look into them and buy all their stuff. So, all right. Now we are at 180, so boom, boom. I need to take a look at, let's see, the surface. Mining and food are coming up next. This has power. How much power are you generating per turn right now?
Me, 10.
10. Jeez. I'm at 6. Initiative.
Encountered in earnest.
Yes. Alien ships humming through the ether have reached Earth in many ways, ending the first chapter in the book of the United Nations of Earth's bid for stellar empire.
I found an alien culture.
Did you?
I did.
Where be this alien culture?
The beta aliens is what they're calling themselves.
Oh.
They are to my south-ish?
Oh, yeah, they're with my science ship. Okay, let's hope they are peaceful.
I hope so, because that's the survey that I'm researching or exploring. Surveying, sorry. Technical terms. Get it straight, Dragon. Well, get it straight. Whack, whack.
That's funny. Surveys. Survey, blah, blah, blah. I don't see any habitable worlds yet.
I have two within the nebula.
Do you? Okay.
Yeah. Plus, this is new to me because the starting place for where I'm at, I'm in a three sun area.
A three sun area? Good God.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. It's a class K sun, a class M sun, and a class G sun.
Wow. I have Jupiter over here. All the planets are here.
Awesome.
They also hated me when I did Imperials with howitzer defense line and move it forward bit by bit. Well, yeah, they can't break it, right? It's good stuff, man. Yeah, now this is very chill because we're just waiting for stuff to happen.
Yeah, it's just a basically, okay, guys, go. Yeah. And then you sit back and just, hey, man, what's going on?
If you ever want to increase the speed, we can.
No, I'm leaving that all up to you. I'm not going to touch the speed because I don't know. Like, for me, I can adjust myself to the speed. I don't know how fast you can play.
Okay. We can play to fast and then to fastest.
There you go.
So we'll just leave it at fast for now since we're kind of waiting. You'll see the gauges on the right, you know, go a lot quicker, obviously.
Mm-hmm.
Man, that's a big survey, man. Mm. Both of these places.
Where did you survey, by the way?
Aranus and Kasora.
Oh, so that's you.
Oh, that's you then.
Aranus, yeah, that's... Yeah, I was about to say, yeah, because look at Aranus, though. That's very, very pretty stars. Class B star, Class A star, Class F star.
Oh, wow, yeah, I just zoomed in. Dang, man. It's
very pretty. Very, absolutely. Very pretty. Evading hostile. But yeah, that's me. So.
Oh no. Hostile fleets? Where?
Uh oh.
Yep. Crap. They're in my area? Why are they in my area?
Oh no.
No way. Are there pirates? Is this pirates? It's just 104 attack. I should be able to take it.
Hopefully.
Oh dang.
It's like, don't attack me, sir. Please don't attack me. I didn't do anything wrong.
Yeah, indeed. Go away. Skillfully disabled a ship in the cultist armada. Okay, cool. It seems like I got the edge. Empire has
established communications. We are receiving a transmission from the United Nations of Earth. They awesome. Appear to have successfully translated our language. Alright!
First contact with the Skuldari Confederacy.
Yay!
Let's see. I bring greetings from Reverend Elder Dhakam, the elected leader of the Skuldari Confederacy. I try to do your voice. I don't know if I'm doing that right with this race or not.
Oh, you're doing it. Like, I've never said a voice for that, so.
I kind of adopted that for one of the characters in Chrono Cross the other day.
I mean, I could go, Arhana family. I mean, I could speak him like that. That could
That's,
be
this does seem like a Stitch race. Might as well.
Oh, indeed. Indeed. Races of Stitch. Yes.
Awesome. I don't got to change my voice at all. I'm human over here. All right. We are delighted to meet you, Skildarians. All right. This is a momentous occasion. But now, what we can do is to research... Wait, can we? What is this? This is... Why can't we research? Oh, really? Interesting. It's weird.
So we should probably do you want to make a federation type thing or?
Yeah, if you want, that would be good.
Okay, I don't know if I can yet because I don't have that ability. I don't know if Earth starts with that.
They should. Let's see. Hang on, that attack just completely threw me off my course here. Hostile fleets, Fist of God. Okay.
There we go. And then, non-aggression pact. There we go.
I see it. Okay. Agree.
Yay!
Working together.
Yep, yep. And then as soon as we're able to get the Federation, I can, or you and our, or I can start that up. So that would be awesome.
Okay.
Doesn't matter. I mean, I don't want to take away from what you actually have to do, but like if you find something that's better for you to do, then by all means do it. But
sure.
I probably could set up the Federation. I don't know if I can actually go there yet. Yes, I actually could.
Yeah, if you want to set that up, that's perfectly fine.
Diplomacy, yeah.
I'm curious of what's happening in my system, because it says I have a hijacked fleet here from the previous hostile fleet. No. I'm not exactly sure what to do with this thing, because... board cultist ship. I'm confused what this does. I don't remember. I haven't run into this situation before. It says it has one military ship in orbit. I can't research because of that. But how do I get rid of this thing?
Mm-hmm.
Confusion. Let's see.
For the glory of the Centauran Empire.
I have no idea what to do with that thing. Okay, well, whatever.
Hello, Final Fantasy keyboard covers. How you do?
Oh, is he in here? What's up, buddy? How you doing? I just recently subscribed to this guy because he checked out some of my covers that I did.
Nice.
And he's doing a really great job with like the Final Fantasy series. He just recently did a 4, and he's got a lot of 7 on there, so I definitely would check it out. But yeah, he uses 2 keyboards at the same time, actually, and tries to replicate like the sounds as they are in the game. And it's pretty cool. So, let's see. Okay, I'm just doing whatever right now. Okay, I'll worry about that later, I guess. That's weird. I've never seen that before. Hijacked fleet. Okay. Where's the repair? Ships. Repair. There we go. Okay. Does it show me as green or yellow?
It shows me as still yellow.
Okay. I think, let's see. More Federation benefits open up when you accrue unity, or not unity, influence. Because that worked. Did you ever play Civ?
Yes. Okay. Played it a long time ago.
That works like the, how is that? The culture track.
Yes.
So that's how that works. We have to get to 1,000? Or how much? I don't know. Wait, no, it's unity. It is unity. Complete. Not influence, it's unity. Okay, mm-hmm. Cool. Traditions available. Oh, well, there it is. Speak of the devil. Okay. All right. Now we can pick which one we want. So, since we're working together, let's take a look at some of these. Are you in the same screen as I am, I'm assuming?
I don't know what screen you're looking at.
It's the traditions screen. So there should have been should have been something that popped up. Maybe not for you yet, I'm not sure. But something that pops up that allows you to pick the traditions. There's expansion, domination, prosperity, harmony, supremacy, diplomacy, and discovery. Let's see. Trust growth increased by 33%. That could work.
Oh, my traditions is still... I need, like, one more point.
Oh, okay. Let's get that to you then. That way we can both look at this.
Yeah, what I'm going to go for is diplomacy.
Okay. Then we should both do that then, I suppose.
No, that's...
Wait.
No, if I get to the Federation, I can offer you into the Federation, and then...
That's right.
Yeah.
So I can maybe do...
There we go. You can pause it now.
Okay.
But yeah, I'm going for the diplomacy. Diplomatic influence cost reduced by 50%, and your trust growth increased by 33%.
Hmm. Yeah, I saw that too. Yeah, that's good. Yeah, you can go for that tree. I'll do something else, I suppose.
Yes.
Anomaly discovery chain. Discovery sounds interesting.
Although it increases how fast you can survey planets.
Right.
And increases your research speed if you finish it by 10%.
Hmm. Expansion is good for later.
Harmony increases your population growth.
Yep. Prosperity.
If you go prosperity, you get your shipyard costs and building costs reduced by 15%. That's what I'm going for next.
Mm-hmm. Are you going to do all the diplomacy or just get to the Federation?
I'm just going to get the Federation, so that way we can actually be in a Federation together. So. Okay.
Greetings, Brute Squad. How you do, sir? That's my neighbor.
Nice.
Hello, neighbor. Yeah, FF, this is Stellaris. If you enjoy the sci-fi style of games, then this is definitely for you. Or if you enjoy strategy games, big scale, then this is kind of like Civ. It's basically Civ in space. All right. Demand vassalization. No, I think I might go to Discovery. All right, let's adopt that.
There you go.
Cool. Repairs complete. Good. Surveyed. Awesome. So I need to redo those science ships. Okay, so I'm going your way. Survey the system that way.
So what I'll do is, because Ernest, I'll scan it like I do, because I guess I could pull back from it, because I'll leave that Ernest for you, and you can branch out that way into your little pocket down below you. What I'll do is I'll go around, because I don't want to cave you in, though, so that's a problem.
Yeah, yeah, I can go south and branch and off that way.
I can start branching towards the center.
So where do you want to border at?
We can border at Ernest.
Ernest. Let's see.
Are you?
Oh, you mean Ernest, the pretty star thing?
Yeah. Okay. You can have that.
All right. So, you want me to have that? Okay.
Yeah, you can have it. It's got 7 energy credits. So you
yeah, that's what I was it. Eyeing. Yeah. I was like, that sounds pretty cool. Yeah. We need to build an outpost though.
I've moved my ship back so I can survey Tramborton, so that way I can see what resources I can get from there.
Indeed. Eventually, we'll be able to share maps. So
yes.
Yeah, that'll be useful. I think Discovery is still the best opening tree for most empires. Yeah, it seems so. Just because of survey. I mean, that's the what you start with. You might as well do it.
Mm-hmm. So.
Cool. All right. Yeah, I'm not gonna mess with the speed too much, just because it throws me off sometimes. But you know, if we're waiting too long, then yeah, I'll definitely manipulate it.
Yeah, it's just I'm just here to chill with you, dude.
Yep, absolutely. It's a Saturday, man. This is usually my day off, so you might as well chill as well. So to do a chill stream is pretty much the same thing. So.
I mean, all streams should be chill in earnest, but...
That's true. Yeah, research. That's good. Let's see. Also, plus 10% research speed when you finish it. Yeah, absolutely. Brute, question. What is with this hijacked ship right here? There was a fleet that came in and started to attack me, so I destroyed them, but there's one ship left... that's hijacked. What do I do with this thing? Because I can't do this right here, the event, until this ship is gone, apparently. I can't research it, so that would be interesting to know if you know anything about that. So diplomacy and expansion. Yeah, that seems reasonable, so I'll probably go that route. Yeah, what do I do with that ship? Do I take him into my colony? That would be nice. Help out, buddy. Do your part.
It's like, hey, we have cookies and ice cream. It's like, oh, I like cookies and ice cream. Okay, I work for you.
Here, grab a shovel. And you can have cookies and ice cream later.
Yay!
It's an event chain. Go fight it, and it will go to the next event. I can't fight it. It will not let me fight. If I click on my military fleet and right-click this guy, it does not fight it. Yeah. It says hijacked fleet. I do not know, man. Might as well figure this out while we're waiting.
No, take your time, dude.
Yeah. I'm just so confused. Send a science ship to it, maybe? I tried. Like, if you choose a science ship, and you click on the event right here, it'll say move here, but there's no research options. So like a science ship to go here to is to do a research, right? That is currently grayed out because this event has this military ship in here. And if I just right click on the ship itself, the science ship will just move to this ship. So I'm confused on what this is. This is kind of a hindrance, actually. So I would like to get rid of to explore this event right here.
Lame. Lame.
Everything is lame, complete. Man. Lame. All right, now. Construction is finished. Excellent. Let's go ahead and get that in a J.
There you go.
Awesome.
And there's three planets, three suns in there. That's why it's... Or, well, you only get two of them. You get Ernest B and Ernest A.
Yeah.
So Ernest A has four and Ernest B has three. Right. Too bad Ernest C doesn't have anything.
Yeah, it's a shame.
That would be overkill.
Absolutely. A leader has gained a level. Very good.
My leader, through sheer work and determination, has gained a new thing.
Oh, awesome.
Yeah. Expertise psionics. Research speed for psionics is plus 15%.
That was it. He called it.
Nice.
I think I had the option to do research. So the military ship had to right click the event and then click research project. Like,
okay.
Never seen that, but whatever. I'm glad we solved that. Thank you, sir. Remind me to make you a batch of cold brew later.
Ooh, that sounds tasty.
Yeah, I've got some in the fridge, actually. I might go grab some. Let's see. Which one is this? That's the one going up, so I need to go up this way. Actually, I don't need to, because you're going to explore to the left, right?
I'm going to the right, yeah.
Are you exploring this constellation to the left, though, of your main?
Where you're at? Where the three energy...
No, you see where the Trambodon is, or whatever that is?
Yes.
Okay, up...
I'm at Trambodon.
Yeah, up and to the left. You plan on doing those, right?
Yes,
okay, so I need to go to the left of my capital, then.
Yes.
Terrorists?
No, there's terrorists. Really?
You're getting all the fun. God, what is this mess?
This is not fun. This is madness, I tell you. Madness.
Shh, it's fun.
Let it happen. Let it happen. Oh, whatever. Okay, my God, we've got a lot of things to do. Let's see. Track. Oh, jeez. That's all, like, within your area.
What?
These objectives that I'm supposed to be doing. One is in Trambodon, one's to the north, and one's to the left of that.
Oh, well, I mean, by all means, come in and we have open borders, or if we don't, I can set it up.
I think we should. Unless we have to...
I don't have closed borders on you, so...
Okay. I think I have to survey that first, though. Dang it. I just now... wait, no, I can. I can move there.
Yeah, you can. Just because you survey an area doesn't mean you have to starport it.
Right. But then I can't go up, can I? Because I have to survey that first.
For the areas that you need to go to, just send your science ship there. Survey that part, and then get what you need to get done, and then come back.
Yeah. That's what I was saying, because like I just now recently moved the other science ship. It's like, crap. That's fine. He still hasn't moved out of the system yet, so. Thank goodness for normal speed.
System survey.
Mess with that too much. All right. This is Sparta. No, this is Stellaris.
This is Stellaris.
Boom. Stellaris kick. Only science ships can go to... Yeah, exactly. Barnard Star. Let's see, this guy's done. Alright, go down here. Complete. Let's see. I'm wondering if the music can be heard well. That seems pretty low.
science ship under attack.
Are you for real?
Oh my goodness. Science ship has encountered an alien vessel.
Crap.
Get out of there. Are you invading me?
No.
It says you are.
Me?
Yeah. Oh, there goes my science ship. Oh, my science ship just got destroyed.
Mine's missing in action.
Oh my goodness.
No, there's cultists there.
Oh, so you know what? I'm going to send my...
Their attack power was really high, too.
Oh, was it?
It was 304. It's like way higher than our first fleet. Man, that's going to provide a problem.
Well, yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Got to get some military up in here, I suppose.
Mm.
All right, I guess it's time. Crap.
Already, man.
Yep. That's fine.
That's perfect.
I can deal with this. It's nonsense. Which one to build here? Oh, that's 2 and 2. I really don't want to boost it. Nah. Forget it. Jeez, what is happening? Uh-oh. That's mine. Complete. Crap. He's gonna kill me.
Yeah, he's already killed mine. I have to build another one.
No. Anomaly found. How do I retreat?
Retreat!
Can I retreat? I don't think I can. Oh, I'm engaged. Man, he's got some stuff.
Hmm.
All right. Well, they're dead anyway. Doesn't matter. I'm gonna have to just start from scratch with that. Crap. Okay. Corvette. God, they're so expensive though.
Yeah, they are.
Almost regretting not taking that reduced ship cost policy.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, great. Well, speaking of policies, there's another one. All right, what's within discovery here? I'm going to pause.
Let's okay. See.
There we go. Survey ship. Increase
speed. Wow, you get Unity a lot faster than I do.
What's your generation?
I am at 78.
Plus.
Oh, my generation is +3.
+3. So is mine. I think you're just like right behind me, like 1 point for whatever reason. I might have started with like a couple more than you did or something. It was weird.
I don't know. Mine cost 132.
Let's see.
So I'm at 78. That's okay though. If you produce faster, it's probably something dealing with the humans.
Maybe so. Research alternatives increased by 1. No. Survey speed increased by 34%. Disengage chance increased. That can be good for now, actually. Supremacy. Let's destroy everyone. Start.
Well, supremacy does reduce.
Yeah.
Your shipbuilding cost.
Yeah.
Or no, supremacy.
That's prosperity. Let's see.
Oh yeah, prosperity.
Speed. Energy output increased by. Trading house produced 1 additional. Let's go with this one. Stick to discovery for a bit. Let's see a few that are beneficial. I just need to just spam military ships for a little bit. Sucks. I don't like doing that, really. We're supposed to be passive and peaceful people. What's wrong with
passive
you?
And peaceful? Yes.
No, it's like no. We're gonna take over your stuff.
Oh, you want to be passive, eh? Well, only the strong survive. Let's show you.
Exactly.
Whatever, man. Whatever. Let's see. My construction is a little bit down. I do have plenty of energy though, so it's not like I'm hurting for resources. I'm just gonna have to hold off for a little bit.
Yeah, it's just a grindy fest now.
Yep. Really, that's only 6 energy. That's... I don't know. Some of it's poor. Ships spawned when your ship entered the system. But ignore the event until you get a second or third world up and running. Building military at this point will just hamper your economy. I was thinking about that, like, yeah. So just don't enter that area, apparently. So, yeah, I'll have to ignore the event for now. Complete. Okay, that's fine. It makes total sense.
I do have a question for you, though.
Yep.
Is there a way, say you have two fleets, one with a general, one with not a general. Is there a way to combine them?
Yes, there's a merge option.
Okay.
Let's see. If you... Let's see. It should be grayed out. Fleet transfer ships. Gray fleet. Disband. There it is. Okay, so if you click on your military fleet,
mm-hmm.
top left-hand corner of the panel, merge.
I'm in fleet manager, so...
Well, like, yeah. Do you have your outliner on the right?
I do.
Okay, so you see your military fleets?
Or do you have... I see one of them, yes.
Okay, so if you click on that, and the panel that pops up in the bottom left...
Yes.
You look in the top left of that panel, it says merge.
Yeah. Okay.
So this works like operating system does. You can control click and select multiple, and then they should merge together. So if they're in the same system.
That's probably. Well, I mean, I think they are in the same system. They're just so farther away from each other.
Or shift click, sorry, not control click, I'm dumb. The merge. There we go.
There we go.
When your economy is strong, 300 fleet power is trivial. Yeah, I know. I've actually gotten to the point where I've been able to spawn military ships pretty frequently, but even then it didn't matter because I was playing with Fallen Empires, which was silly. Silly. All right. Let's do that. Robots, no. Entrepreneurs. Not really a fan of any of this. Armor, I guess. Yeah, for defense. Sure, go with that. Okay, there's a 3-star one. Right below me. Let's do that one. Suppose I can build an outpost here. It's okay. It's just only 3 and 2, though. 3 mining and 2 research. How much is a star base? 100. Sure. I'd like to get to the point where we're doubling up on construction ships. That'd be nice.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I gotta be careful, though, because my stream playthrough that I did, I wound up running out of energy credits quickly, so...
Yeah, that was actually my first couple of playthroughs that I did of this game, and I'm like, why am I running out of energy so fast? Oh, maybe if I learn the game, it'll work out. So, but,
And I wound up dismantling a bunch of mining ships. I'm like,
Yeah. It was unfortunate.
So now I learned just, like, if I'm not going to use them right off the bat, like, oh, my materials are pretty good. Yeah. Like, why need the things for more? So.
Indeed.
Like, it's a waiting game to beginning anyway, because you're trying to rush, and it doesn't work that way.
Exactly. Yeah, this is extremely passive, so y'all take your time. Oh, man. All right, let's see what the surface is doing here. I need to get rid of some of these tile blockers. Let's see. Energy is always a good option to clear off. That costs 100 energy. Yeah, do that. Yeah. Let's also get that. Okay, two's enough. This can use a building. Power plant. Boom. Yeah, Brute Scribe will also have to get you in on this at some point to co-op, like in the future or whatever, after we do our first playthrough. Be cool to do like three players or something.
Yeah, for sure.
Yep. Do you
and
have
then
the
we all team up and just bully everybody?
Oh, do what now? What'd you say?
I said then we can all team up with one another and just bully everybody else.
Exactly, exactly. Yeah, he said he's down. Cool. Do you have the DLC, Brute? What's this? Oh, research is up. Survey speed again. Oh my goodness. I might have to. Automatic exploration. Well, well, well. Research speed, though. I'm torn. Survey speed. Crap. I hate when I do that to you. It's like, do you want research speed or do you want survey speed? I don't know, man. Survey speed was 25%, though, as opposed to 5. So, except for the very latest one. What's the very latest one? Is it Apocalypse? I can't remember. So I know system I bought all of them. I'm pretty sure I did. Science ship is done. Good. Let's go to the 2-star. Man, that sucks. There's that little anomaly in between our empires. It's like, come on, man. Really? It's lame.
Okay, I am able to now get Federation.
Excellent, let's do it.
All right. Invite to Federation.
Incoming transmission.
Incoming transmission.
The galaxy is dark and full of terrors, human. Join us in a Federation for mutual protection.
Yeah!
I agree.
Yes!
Oh, you're blue now.
Yes.
Awesome.
And you're purple. So
I'm purple?
We are one.
Okay.
We are one.
Alright, so we have a Federation. I've never done a Federation before, so let me see what the view is like.
Construction complete.
So, ships, armies, planets.
You see basically what I see.
That's pretty much it. Okay, cool.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Excellent.
I don't even know if we share resources. That'd be kind of cool if you did.
Anomaly found.
Be cool to trade.
Oh, we can trade anyway.
That's true. That's true. We can if we can, if we need to.
It's like, hey, I'll give you this if you give me this. Or, hey, do you need some? Yes. Send me some of this nice food I have. Like, okay. What do you want? I'll catch you back later. Don't worry.
Would you like to barter? Oh, I don't know. Are you a good haggler?
Indeed, indeed.
A little jolly good.
Surveying one system at a time.
Indeed. I'm gonna turn the music up on this guy. Let's see.
The music is pretty awesome.
Yep. All right. If that's too loud for anybody, let me know. It shouldn't be. The music's pretty soft anyway, so.
Soft, nice and calming.
Soft music. Yeah, yeah. All right. What does the surface look like? It's about halfway done. Let's see. Two. Well, dang, I should have built it there. Didn't even think about that. Oh, that's fine. I might be able to get away with another construction ship. I don't know. Yeah, that's a little too ambitious. Because outposts, all that. That's fine. Whatever. Doing well on energy, though. That's a good thing.
Yeah, I'm still a positive, so mm-hmm. Yeah.
speeding up for a sec.
Okay, take your time. Actually, pause it for a second. Should I go with fusion reactors, basic combat rolls, or blue lasers?
Let's see. What's the benefits? What's the tooltips on them?
The tooltips is... nuclear fusion process generates a great amount of power for ships, but without many of the risks associated with fission power. Basic combat rolls activate matrices tuned for specific combat-centric tasks, greatly improving engagement efficiency. And then blue lasers is more powerful than red lasers. The blue variant emits electromagnetic radiation at wavelengths that appear blue or violet to the most organics.
Hmm. It seems to be all, like, militaristic.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I really can't say. I would say blue lasers probably, but whatever it's going to cost the least.
Actually, fusion power and fission and the blue lasers are 765, both the same.
Okay, what's the third?
It's combat rolls, which is...
Well, what's the cost on that one?
It's 1020.
Oh, God.
Yeah,
pick one of the 765s. Yeah, either one. Either one. Totally right, up I'll to
go
you.
Blue, go blue lasers. Sounds so that good. Way, if I can upgrade, retrofit my ships, and then be like, hey, I shoot blue lasers. Pew, pew.
Frost PDP's in the stream. What's up, buddy? That's a fellow Brigandine player right there.
Hello.
Dragonwhelp is here. He's saying hello to you, man.
Welcome to the stream. Mario thanks you.
Mario's in space? Oh, man. He's back.
Why not?
Nah, he's everywhere anyway, right? He's in every single Mario galaxy. is it like CK2? No, it's like Civ. It's like Civ. Switch to the host expansion packs. I think so, yeah. I'm pretty sure whoever joins the host gets access to the expansion packs. Let's see. Yeah, dude. Let me know if you get back on it.
You can't join anybody without, like, if I didn't have all the expansion packs that you did, I wouldn't be able to join you.
Hmm. Okay.
Awkward. Or at least that's what I read, so.
I see. Because I know Dungeon of the Endless lets other people join. But I don't think they get to take advantage, though. I'm not sure. Like, some of the features, yes, like inside game, but, like, character-wise, definitely not.
Right.
But. Anywho.
And I think we can have people join on the fly, can we not? And they just take a random AI spot.
Probably so. Probably so. Depending on how it looks, someone might want to do that. It's like, oh, these guys are kicking your butts. Let's go ahead and take control of this.
Sure, why not?
Indeed. Surface complete. I can now upgrade, but it costs a lot. Just get one of them. It's fine. So, Brute said the Federation can build fleets that are controlled by the current president, which would be you. So, I'm not sure exactly how to go about that. I've not explored these features whatsoever. If you click the bottom right icon, there's members and there's fleets. And then you should have access to the Federation ship designer, possibly. Do you see what that is? Do you have access to it?
I have access to it, yeah, and I'm actually going through and I can actually make a new design for a ship.
How about that? Let's go. Let's go. I wish you could put your logo on it. That'd be funny.
I think you can.
You probably can, yeah. It'd be hilarious to, like, have a whole bunch of Dragon Whelp ships, like, flying around here. That'd be amazing.
Because, I mean, right now I don't know how to describe what I'm seeing up here.
Yeah.
I got some red lasers. I mean, I have the interceptors. Like, I could choose what weapons they have on them. I can also choose what kind of armor deflectors, what kind of reactors they have,
mm-hmm.
how much they cost, how much, it's like, it's really hard to say.
Wow.
It's really hard to explain.
That sounds pretty deep.
Yeah, it's really, really deep. I mean, I could do like auto though, but I don't know.
I mean, I suppose you could, just to save time. I mean, learn the ins and outs of it later, but...
Unless there's a way to actually set you up to be that as well. But I don't know. Two leaders of the Federation?
I'm not sure. He just said current president, so we'd probably have to swap roles or whatever, but...
Oh, current president. I don't know who the current president is.
That would be you.
Oh.
Yeah, so like, if you are able to access this, I can't. It's right. Grayed out for me. It says the Federation president isn't one of our leaders. So one of your leaders is the president. You probably find out, actually. If you go to the top right under more and go to leaders, it probably would say. I don't know. Maybe under generals or admirals? Governors, maybe?
Planets and sectors, policies and edicts, factions... Strategic resources, species leaders. There we go.
Yeah.
Construction complete.
Fan, thanks for stopping by. I appreciate the like. Hope you're doing well. You have a good day with your friends.
Yeah, I don't know who the president is.
Brute says the presidency will rotate every few years.
Oh, okay.
So I guess it's just going to rotate between. Every 10 years, you said? Okay. Rotate between factions, I guess.
That sounds cool.
So I guess it just passes to me then, right? Yeah.
Passes it back and forth, probably. Yeah.
It only makes sense. So.
Cool. Well, then I'll let you do all the technical making of the ships and stuff.
Okay. Well, you can feel free to make what you like, because it's going to be a while before it passes. So.
Honestly, I don't know.
I'll take a look at it later on, but all right, cool.
Because only design I have is the Corvette, which is the
ship basic
that I mm-hmm. use.
It's an empty module slot on the starbase. Does this even matter? Civilian, where merchants and traders can conduct business. Base cost, base time. It gives 4 energy credit. Energy. It's not terrible.
Construction complete.
Sure, we'll build a trading hub. Why not? I've never used one, but I can only assume it just gives you 4 energy credits to your generation. Have you looked at your starbase?
Starbase.
Yeah, if you look on the outliner under shipyards, you can click on one of your stations there. And you have defenses, shipyard, and starbase in the bottom left for tabs.
Yes.
Okay, so for starbase, is there like a module slot available for you with a plus? Or yes. Is it all red? Okay. That's where
I have a slot available.
Yeah, that's where
that's
I'm building
the only
one trading
around
hub.
My planet, though.
Okay.
What do you recommend I put there?
I probably would say just a trading complete. Hub, because it seems like that gives you +4 to your energy generation.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Because it says base cost and then time, and then it says energy credits 4. I can only assume that means like +4 to your generation.
Right.
Why would it cost just 4 to build that? So,
situation.
Maybe it does. I don't updated. Know. Construction ship is done. Good. Let's build research. There might be more to it than I'm seeing. I'm not sure. I don't know. Even if it's just a flat 4, I'm cool with that. So
Yeah, flat four is nice.
Yep. Yeah, he verified plus four base. Okay, cool. I'm down to do that with the main empire. Like, things that are like closer to borders or whatever could probably use more military modules.
Right.
But, yeah.
The main hub, yeah, that
seems like good for trade. Edicts, martial law. What does this do? Last 11 years, unrest minus 50%. I don't think that's important
construction
now.
Construction complete.
I don't even know what unrest does, but like, it doesn't seem important right now. 270 for those mining stations. All right.
That's why you only pick and choose what mining stations you need.
Indeed. Wow, this one has a 9 energy, 4 research mining, and 2 complete. Research.
Jeez.
I found Alpha Centauri. Oh, wow.
Did you really?
Yeah, nice. Yeah, I did. It's got a 3 stars in it. Can you see it?
Yeah, I see it. Yeah. Oh, right. Dude, that's awesome.
Yeah. A, B. Yep. Cool. All right. Research complete. Defense army damage. Monthly unity. Monthly unity plus 2? That seems like a no-brainer. Yeah, definitely. Give me unity.
Give me unity or give me death.
I was waiting for it. Oh, man. I think of the punchlines and I'm like, nah, I think my partner will say it, probably. And indeed he did, so.
Great minds think alike, good sir. Great minds think alike.
Absolutely. All right. Influence borders are pretty close. Let's see. They expand? Yeah, they should.
If you get, was it this Kasora right here, they will touch.
I think I'll do that next once this ship is finished. I'll have enough. Man, you should sit down and chill to this soundtrack on YouTube sometime. It's really, really nice. Eleven energy? 13? Still haven't done surveying this stuff. Oh my gosh.
Jeez.
How much energy are we going to cap out on over here? I need to grab this up, like, immediately. Let's see. Is it the 2? Yes, the 2. Okay.
Yeah, I'm already up to plus 14.
Excellent. I'm at 17 right now. What's your mining?
Plus 15.
Okay. 1, 2. That's some good research one right there. Excellent.
Situation log updated.
What? What is the situation? No.
Construction complete.
It's 2 out of 8. Scientist is present. Wait, what? Oh, I see. Okay. All right. We're going to connect these borders, my friend.
Yay! Right.
Build the star base. And do coals.
Yeah, I'm just waiting. I'm waiting for influence and minerals now just to be able to build more star bases.
Yep. Still not done surveying that area. Wow. Can we get more energy out of that? Who knows? So Alpha Centauri is habitable.
System survey complete. Nice.
Mm-hmm.
I'm definitely gonna have to build another colony there. Let's see. Okay. Researcher. Good. Scripted to be near Terrans, for real? It's probably here, then. I'll find out here in a second. Do you have 3 construction ships?
Mm-hmm.
Wow. Okay, maybe I should at least double up.
I've got 3 science and 3 construction.
Wow. That's a bunch. Alright. Discovery. Is your unity up or no?
Actually, no. I have 181 unity.
Okay. Let's see. I'm gonna pause real quick.
Yeah, take your time.
Research alternatives, no. Allow science ships to assist research. That's actually good. A colony is increasing planetary research production. Maybe. That actually would be pretty handy. What was it everyone was going to do? Probably expansion. Yeah, colony development speed. It's getting close to new colony time, but I think I'll do one more and then go to expansion. What's the other ones? Leader experience gain. Okay. Gain unity equal to 3 months of production whenever a new technology is researched. Wow. Okay. Is there like an all bonus? Yeah, a finisher effect. Adopting all discovery traditions increases our research speed by 10% in addition. Unlock 1 ascension perk slot. Mm-hmm. I do not know what an ascension perk is.
Ascension perk, look immediately to its right.
Oh, right. I have never used these, actually.
I've never used them either.
Huh, interesting. Odd, can't know what they are. It's a secret.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Sure, we'll go with databank uplinks so we can get a science ship on there. So, great. Might build a new one in that case. Seems reasonable. Yeah, let's do it. Why not? And then, we need another scientist. Let's see. Survey speed? No. Research speed. Yep. Yep, you win. Welcome aboard. Should have unpaused that, shouldn't I? Do we want to make progress? If we want to make progress. If you want
to, I'm just waiting on you.
No. Too many space games. I got you. Where are you pulling Terrans from? What game are you pulling Terrans from? Just StarCraft or?
Terrans. It sounds like StarCraft, yeah.
I loved their theme, man. It was so good in StarCraft 1. Oh, Galciv? Okay, I got you. I have not played Galciv yet. I think I have the third one. I'm not sure. Or maybe I have 2, because one of them was free not too long ago.
Special project complete. Construction complete.
Okay, let's see. You are going to survey this other 3-star next to you. I believe. Yep. Already. Oh, wow. Let's see. Okay, so how does this happen? Wait, no, I haven't even researched it yet. You know what? Yes, I have. I got it from Unity. How do I start this up? Assist research. Requires a scientist. Derp. I got a leader there for a reason, didn't I? Forgetting
construction
stuff.
Construction complete.
All right.
It's alright. It happens.
I know. Assist. Excellent. I wonder if it's better to put, like, a higher level one and just let this one go off and gain experience, maybe. Yeah, I think I'll switch them out as soon as like the next survey is finished, and take the highest level one, which is, I think you. Skill level 3 out of 5. You're 2 out of 5. Yeah, okay. So I'll take the level 3, bring him here and research. If it matters, I'm not sure. I'm assuming it would. Also, basically, is Civ in space, right? Much more so than Solaris. Indeed. Probably because you're not even on the timer. Complete. But special project is complete. Very good. Now you will do something. I'm not sure. Hi, Paris.
Meow.
Meow. She's so noisy. Let's see. Survey. Let's see, what are we doing over here? Okay, so the borders are pretty much connected, I guess. I mean, it's still kind of separated, but...
I mean, we have to get Trambodon. Like, we gotta get in there and get that.
That's right, yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Suppose I could build stations here, or do I want to bring this over and build on Alpha Centauri? I gotta build a star base out here. So yeah, do that.
Yeah. I'm trying to get my military power up enough so I can go take out those hostiles.
Indeed.
So I could start working on that place.
Yep, we gotta get that out of there for you. So 90. Also 90. Okay.
Oh no!
What?
I'm being invaded.
Are you? Wait.
Yeah, automated dreadnought.
Oh geez.
A massive warship has been discovered patrolling the Bulk Brimar system. No lifetimes can be detected on the vessel, but it emits a very strong power signature and appears to be blistering with weapon systems. It does not respond to hails.
Okay.
Sheesh.
I hope you'll be okay up there.
Yeah, I'll be alright.
I don't necessarily have the means to help with the military.
Yeah, my science ship went in there and said, "Hello, Dreadnought." And he went, turns right back around and goes, "Nope."
Goodbye, Dreadnought.
Exactly.
How do we get more of these? Maybe upgrading the starbase will unlock additional slots. Right, okay. Upgrade is expensive on Starbase. Man,
yes,
oh man.
It is.
Okay. That's not until way later.
By the way, you are able to buy... if you go to your shipyard, you should be able to buy the Federation-class Corvette.
Let's see. It says Falcon class. Auto best...
Oh, okay, apparently. Do you not see Federation Corvette?
I do not.
Okay.
Defense platform, no. Yeah, in the shipyard, all I see is just the regular Corvette.
Yeah.
I think you're only able to build them. Like, when it passes to me, I'll probably be able to build it. Which is kind of silly.
But yeah, that is really silly. It's like, why am I the only one able to build them?
What? Exactly, exactly. Because I should be able to benefit from that, too. I mean, have my own fleets.
If you see Federation in parentheses and then says the Corvette, if you look at the class, it's called Federation class. Found.
Okay.
So you should be able to, if you see the Federation thing, you should be able to buy some as well. They're really powerful.
Let me see.
It wouldn't be in your planet's star base or your planet shipyard. It should be in your shipyard.
Yeah, that's where I was looking. Yep, just Corvette.
Really?
Regular. Yep.
Oh, okay. That's silly.
Yeah, Brute Squad. Any advice on this? We're trying to figure out if I can actually build Federation ships when I'm not actually in control of the ship builder or the designer. Shouldn't I be able to take advantage of building Federation ships? Let me know.
I'm finding so many habitable planets.
Are you?
Yeah. Excellent.
There should be a quest to find 8, I think.
Yes.
Yeah.
Situation. It's in my situational log. I've already completed it.
I've only found 2.
Okay. If you want to send a science ship to Bithia, if you want to send a science ship to Tiastador, I don't even know how to pronounce that. There's one planet there. There's one planet at Bithia. And then if you look over here where Veldoram is, there's 2 planets there.
I have to pass through Tram, but...
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Might have to wait until we get rid of that, then I can complete it.
Yeah,
but
okay.
I should be able to get it, though. Like, there's plenty of stuff down here. It's just being stingy.
Right.
Yeah. Oh, well.
Okay, Sarah, Sarah.
Oh, also, Brute, let me know if they're if it's more beneficial to put like your highest level scientist doing the assistant research. Does it go faster with a higher level scientist, or can I just put like a level 1 scientist to assist research and it's the same? I would assume that you need a higher level scientist to make it go quicker, but let me know. Democratic ruler election. Let me pause real quick. Let's see. This could go either way. Oh, wow. I don't necessarily care. Just, higher level scientists are better for assisting. Okay, I kind of figure. So I'll switch it out when I get the chance. Let's see. Honestly, I would like to get a scientist fully leveled to 5 and then do it. So I might just do that. We'll see. Okay, well, it's fine. I'm indifferent. Complete. Boom.
Do you remember how... Oh, the alien vessels are at 304. Okay. So if I can get my stuff up to better than 304, so it should be good. I'm equipping my fleet with blue lasers.
That's awesome. See, I told you to go for blue lasers. It's working out.
Yeah, man. Blue lasers are awesome.
Situation log updated.
Oh, jeez. Pause. I'm trying to do stuff here. Let's see. God, that is a lot. Research station. I would like to wait for the mining stations, actually, because that's a lot. Okay, yeah, I'll wait for that. It's fine. Then again, that is a lot of turns. Yeah, just go for research. I can make up the difference.
Construction complete.
Okay, there's one available. Also, it's possible to raise max level through research and genetic mods and some government types. That would be useful to get them as quickly to 5 as possible.
Right, mm-hmm.
So let's that's
research complete.
Okay, got the armor. Very good. Corvette hull points. That could be useful. It carries more stuff. Yep, do it. It would raise max level so you could have level 6. Oh, okay. That's cool. 8 or 9 if you go crazy with it. Oh. Yeah, I won't fool with that too much. I really just want to get a scientist to 5 and put them over on the planet to assist. So, just got to keep this level 3 at work. It's going to take a while, but it'll be worth it. Food. Okay, that's fine with me. All right, Odot, I appreciate you stopping by, man. Thanks so much. I'll catch you on Warframe at some point, okay? Have you played that at all, Dragon?
Warframe? Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Who do you like to use, usually?
Oh, goodness, it's been so long since I've played, I don't really remember.
Same. I've only recently started back up with it, but, I liked to play a Necros a lot.
Right.
He was fun. Speed this up a little bit.
Okay.
Traction in the internal landscape of the United Nations of Earth.
Construction complete.
Oh, equality and justice. Well, yeah, I'm down with that. Let's go.
Yes.
Justice
shall prevail. Amendment.
I was waiting for that too. I was like, I had it in my head. Like, I want him to get the punchline, and he did. All right. Let's see. I gotta wait for that. Okay. quite a while, actually. Study it. Why would I give up credits like that? Stupid.
Anomaly found.
Research the anomaly. There's another habitable world. Awesome. Not too bad. Pretty spread out, though. One's adjacent, the other one's kind of far off, but it's not terrible. Alright, speaking of, I need to get a colony ship for real. It's about that time. So. Boom. Oh, my friend, what will you do? I don't know.
Anomaly found.
Slow it down. There we go.
We're going too fast. Slow it down.
Hit the brakes.
That's weird. It's a really good survey over here. Hopefully it gives me a research of each type on one system. That'd be nice.
System survey complete.
Oh, wow. I have a planet over here that has poor energy on it.
Oh, wow. Yeah, definitely.
Yeah.
Let's see. Minor mandate. Okay, planning station is built 4. That's fine. It's done. Okay, if we're just survey.
Wow, you're growing a whole lot faster than I can. Jeez.
What, like the influence area?
Yeah.
Well, it's just outposts. I mean.
Well, no, I'm still, but like my influence takes forever to go up.
Oh, yeah. My influence is +4 now. I think it was lower a little bit earlier.
But... yeah, mine's at +2. This is insane. It's like, move forward in the glory of the Stentaran Empire. I hope you know where that's from. Otherwise, I'm just saying that for nothing.
It sounds familiar. I'm going to have some clarity.
Doctor Who?
Oh, okay. I haven't watched a lot, but I have seen that. So, my brother and my father are huge fans.
Right.
I haven't watched a lot. Yeah, I noticed that, Brute. It cost 150 or 1.5. At the beginning of the game. That's fine. At least we have access to other ships, so... ultimately, we can, hopefully build up a nice fleet just to scare people away.
It's like, ooh, it's scary!
But they looked so peaceful when we saw their picture.
Nope. It's like all you see is like one gigantic dreadnought, and then behind you see like little people cowering in the corner. It's like, be scared, don't go away.
Oh boy. Let's see. Are we done with this colony ship? Well, let's get that to go faster.
Is it beneficial to colonize out?
Oh yeah, like if you have a habitable planet, then you definitely would benefit from colonizing.
Okay.
Construction complete.
Okay, there's that. All right, colony ship. I need you to go to Alpha Centauri. Absolutely.
That's the dream, colonizing Alpha Centauri.
Indeed. Don't colonize, you'll get swallowed up. Yeah, definitely.
Anomaly found.
Colony ships are expensive. But they're definitely worth it. They take a lot of energy, like when they're out, so you want to colonize as soon as possible. But yeah.
Okay. As soon as there we go. I was about to say, as soon as I was able, I was going to build a colony ship.
Yep.
I actually had to save up for it.
Indeed. Oh, you're still waiting. Okay.
I found a planet, Bithia 3,
uh-huh,
that has strong magnetic fields, and it gives me an energy credits output of plus 5%.
That's pretty nice. It's really nice, actually.
It also gives me a tile physics output of plus 5%. I don't know what that means.
Tile physics output. I think physics just pertains to the mining materials, maybe.
Either that or.
Or wait, no, physics research. Physics is a research category.
Okay.
So yeah, it does. It's that's where it pertains to. Is that gonna show up on screen? It's got a desktop notification saying my new microphone has shipped. So.
Yay!
It's good to. So you should be happy to know that it has been purchased. So
it's headed your way.
It is headed my way. It didn't show on screen. Okay. Well, that's fine. I said it anyway. It didn't matter.
But yeah, the blue line of microphones is really, really good.
Yep. That's what I see the majority of.
I have a Blue Yeti myself, and I love it.
I bet. I think Breast Trigger also has one. Yeah, I hear good things.
I mean, you tell me, does it have good sound quality?
Yeah, it's got great sound quality. So.
I love the fact that it says automated dreadnought up there, and it's like it doesn't even tell you what the power is. It just says skull.
It probably means it'll kill you in one shot.
System survey complete.
I hope not.
How do I order this to colonize? Like, this is weird. I'm confused. Why can't I colonize this?
Thank you. No.
What's up?
I'm under attack.
Again? Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
Oh crap.
I'm sending my forces in to take care of things.
Okay.
I just lost a construction ship, but eh, I can always build those.
Mm.
It's like, all right, fleet, move out with your blue lasers. Oh boy, my spaceport's under attack.
I am not understanding. Why can I colonize? This is stupid.
Is there hostile not enough free tiles on the planet?
Evading hostile fleet.
Damn, crap. Now I'm being
You're
attacked.
You're being invaded too. Oh no. I guess the game's like, you must fight.
Dang it. It's in my home system too. In the future, it's easier to order the colony ship from planet. Yeah. Where was that? Let's see. Expansion planner. That's it. Alpha Centauri. Yes, colonize on this portion probably, or this empty one probably. Doesn't really matter, it's four directions in this case, so yeah, do it right there. It is so much easier. Like, why is it so difficult and dumb. Oh my god, he rickrolled me. Unbelievable. Fine, I'll humor you. You only get one. You only get one. Actually, this is number two, so I'm being generous.
Yay, we won the fight.
You didn't put in Rickroll? Yeah, could have fooled me. Let me see. Oh, I see. That's weird. Maybe it's because I didn't let it finish last time. Whatever. Oh my gosh. No, this is lame. Oh my gosh, these guys are ridiculous with their damage and their shields. What in the world? Where did these guys come from?
I don't know. They're like, hello.
Wow.
Do you need some help?
Possibly. He's just gonna like roam around in my home system the entire time.
I'm coming. I don't know how long it'll take me to get there, but I'm coming.
Yeah. Take a bit, but I think he's just gonna sit here and troll me the entire time, probably. Yeah, he's gonna sit here and destroy my research stations and everything, probably.
Oh no, I'm coming to help. I'm coming to help.
Alrighty.
Oh, I have to go through Trambodon. Oh no.
They might not be there.
They might be the ones that are attacking you.
Probably. I'm not taking their power down at all. Like, it's completely one-sided. Why are they so powerful?
No idea.
You must now suffer with the rest of us. The rest of us? I'm only suffering myself. What are you talking
about? It's like, I'm already suffering. What? Come on.
Kobe, it's cool, man. Don't worry. Watch the spam. I'll just harass your mining stations and civilian ships. I don't want them to harass my mining stations and civilian ships. I want production.
Oh, your power's at 35. Come on. Come on.
Like, I'm trying
to... Go faster. Go faster.
I'm trying to build other ships to compensate for this.
Yes.
It's probably not a good idea that I do that. But, it's annoying.
Because you're basically sending them into... You're like... train death, you're just gonna waste a lot of resources.
Yeah.
Cause you send them in like, come on, I gotta get this down. I've got like almost double their power coming in, so.
Okay, great. Yeah, I need to get some more military up and running. Too much neglection.
He's like, no man, come on. Survive. We can't let you fall yet. We can't let you fall yet.
I'm not gonna fall. But I am getting harassed.
Start attacking the home planet, you're gonna be like, oh no! Ooh, incoming transmission from the. What is this? The curators. Curators have found me. From where, though? That's the question.
That makes no sense. Is it seriously blocking my path? Wow, it totally is. This jerk needs to go immediately. Like, I can't move my construction ship past me.
I'm about to lose my ships as well. The Trambodon is people are still here.
God.
This is fast. It's like, No, stop.
Why do we have these issues? Hey, I took them down by 10.
Come on, guys, win. We've got the blue lasers. Remember the blue lasers? They're the best.
Did you outfit them with that?
Yeah, I've retrofitted every one of them with it.
I'm watching your fight.
Come on, guys, you can do it. Go! Go! We're winning.
Yep.
You got
a lot more accuracy and a lot more damage output going.
Come on!
You can do it.
Come on, guys. Come on, guys.
You got it.
Holy cow! Yes, get out of the system, boys! Bye-bye!
Good stuff, man. Wow. Trumped him.
Yes.
Unclaimed systems on your borders. The more systems you have bordering an unclaimed system, the higher chance pirate spawns. Okay.
Okay. So hopefully my ships will be coming your way. I hope I can sit there in your docking bay and repair.
They're at Erinus.
I know.
They left.
Oh, did they?
They left my main system, so I'm no longer fighting them, but yeah. They're in Erinus, so.
179. I'm at 120. I don't know if I can do this. I might have to retreat. And go prepare.
Wait, are you finding them now?
No.
Okay.
I'm gonna put an outpost on Trambodon so that way none of this happens again.
Yeah. That's definite. Alright. Construction ship. What are you doing? Oh, right. Okay, whatever. It's fine.
Yeah, it's gonna take It's gonna take a while to get back to base.
Ooh, mining station lost. Spaceport under attack.
What?
No need.
Traditions. Pause. All right.
Okay.
Let's see. Next is leader experience gained, and then after that, unity. Equal to 3 months of production. Never gonna take much as researched. That could really help out the new colony, actually, if I do this now.
Mm-hmm.
And again, the research speed is desirable, plus the unity is too. I'm trying to understand this. Gain unity equal to 3 months of production whenever a new technology is researched. Huh. That's pretty cool.
So if you're plus 4 unity and then you get a new technology,
yeah,
it basically gives you, if you're plus 4, it'll give you, what, 12 unity?
Yeah. In this case, it would give me 18. Mm-hmm. But that's like forever into the future. So I have to go through 3 more techs, or 3 more traditions to get to that point.
Right.
So I think for now, what I'm going to do is do the colony speed increase with expansion. Capital buildings now produce 1 additional unity. I can get that to help out discovery.
There you go.
Starbase influence cost reduced. Yeah, let's go for expansion. All right. Boom. Unpause.
All right. How's your starbase doing here? Did they take it out yet? Wow. Your starbase there is comparable to their power, so.
Yeah. Should be able to defend it. Just, yeah. But there's
actually,
no.
You're gonna win.
Am I for real gonna win?
Yeah, you're gonna win from your with your star base. Yeah.
That's hilarious because it doesn't say it has any defenses at all. So.
It's shooting rockets out.
Yeah. Just got a basic default type of thing. All right, well, harass all you want, dudes. I don't care. You're just a bunch of douches. Let's see.
System survey complete.
Okay, I have a colony ship now.
Excellent. Yeah, definitely use it.
Yeah, about to go use it on this barren planet.
So, the way that I had to do it was go to more expansion planner and then colonize from here. So if you pick the one that you want to colonize, there should be a colony button. A little colony button next to it to where you can place the first building.
Right.
And wherever that building goes, that should give bonuses to the adjacent tiles, if I'm not mistaken. So.
Man, I'm getting attacked over here again.
Are you? Oh, God.
440 military power. These guys need to get their butts moving. You gotta just get all this riffraff out of here. Come on. Yeah. Just get all this riffraff out of here.
That's a 440 fleet. Oh my god.
Yeah, no, it's really strong.
Jeez.
Okay, I just spent 440 materials to beef up my fleet. So hopefully this works. Come on, guys. It's really weird how they're just sitting there in our home base and they're just getting health. Like, there's no rhyme or reason. They're not even going into the star base. They're just getting health.
Harassment, man. Pure harassment.
Upgrade, go.
Construction complete.
Thanks for the music, Kobe. I appreciate it, man. He's on a Final Fantasy 13 kick, apparently.
Oh, wow.
United Nations of Earth is now the leader of Arch Federation. Okay. So,
yep.
I can now design. All right. Now, so I see the Corvette Federation now. It looks like it should be outfitted. Okay. So save that design. So maybe we can design ships.
Design of your own.
Yeah.
Research complete.
I'm wondering if we can design ships and then pass them back and forth. Like, I design a ship here, and then when it passes to you, you can now use that ship.
Probably.
I'm curious about that. But in any case, that's going to be it. How do we... we should be able to build normally, right?
Yeah.
There it is. Parentheses, Federation. Okay, great. Sure. Build one. Engineering is finished. Mineral storage capacity, not quite. Corvette building speed. Do that.
It's like, go, my friends, go.
Do that. I need things to kill with faster. So. Let's see. Blah 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 blah. It won't take long. Yeah, I totally got Rickrolled. World. Oh well.
Oh,
can now use the ideology Costa's belly against us.
System survey. Complete.
What is that?
I don't know.
Apparently you can use your ideology against me. Somehow, some way. Uh-oh.
It's like voodoo magic.
I'm in trouble now. What do we do with this guy? There's a passive science ship here. That's not good. Okay.
Construction complete.
Earth. Come on. Can't declare war without a Costa's belly. Oh, really? And usually you need to share a border. Okay, I got you.
Special project complete.
Target of Costa's belly. The Skullar Confederacy can now use the... Right. Oh, okay. I know this. Don't really feel like building anything there. Let's see. He's just chilling in that system, man. Just not doing nothing.
Well, my, that 440
yeah.
thing? No, he's destroying my mining ships and stuff.
Oh, did he? Oh, God.
Yeah.
There's a...
I'm sending my big guys after him.
Okay. Oh, I see it coming. Oh, man. I'm going to watch this fight.
I know we're just a little bit weak, but we've got the blue lasers.
Indeed. Go, blue rangers. Let's go. Or, I'm going to say blue ranger. Oh, gosh.
You did say blue ranger.
I did say blue ranger, didn't I? Wow. Look at me go.
Or, no, you said blue razors. So
yeah, I combined rangers and lasers together, and it came out razors.
Ooh, look at the lasers go.
I see them. They're very blue, my friend. They're very blue. Go, blue lasers. Let's go.
Ooh. Come on. Come on. Get them. Get them.
You've got it. Their damage output is zero right now. 2, 8, 30. You're good. You're good. You are good.
Oh. Wow.
Yep. Is that a Federation fleet?
Yeah. No. That's a fleet of my own.
Okay.
But the Federation fleet is basically the same thing as what I have.
Gotcha.
Like the Corvette is just the same thing. I feel sorry for that one guy. He's about to get blown to bits.
Oh, wow. Alpha Centauri is almost finished.
Nice.
Can I not merge the Federation and the regular? It's weird.
No, Federation is separate from the regular ship.
That's fine. No big deal.
But the cool part about this, though, I should be able to say, "Hey, Federation fleet, come here." It won't let me do it.
There's a very strong empire that you don't want to have fight. You can hold them off by not expanding into systems next to them. Well, yeah, sure. Obviously. Let's see. There. Oh, lacking materials? No way. Totally understandable.
Construction complete.
Speed, shop keep.
Colony established.
Yay, Alpha Centauri.
Anomaly found.
Damage.
Construction complete.
Just resource gathering, my dude.
Yep.
Another hostile fleet? Seriously? Oh my god.
Jeez. It's just 259. You can handle that. So. Your shipyard alone should be really powerful anyway.
I'm just going to send the big dogs after them and be like, what's up, man? Come on. Like, hey, but the more you send them out, the more experience they get. And the more the experience they get, the more powerful they
indeed,
get.
Indeed. Indeed. We are on the same page.
Mm-hmm.
Level four scientist.
It's like, sure. It's like, sure, my space station could take them out, but...
This scientist is almost level five. Please hurry. I would love to put that on assistance. What's the timer on this?
Is it telling anomaly me? Found.
No.
System nope. Survey complete.
Sure doesn't.
Oh my goodness, my 409 is just shredding these 264s.
I bet.
Oh my
let me come look at this madness.
Blue lights versus red lasers.
Let me see. Oh,
blue there lasers versus red lasers. We got this.
Oh, wow. Wow. That's like melting. A Peralta melting pot. Would you like some stew? Tasty. Yum, yum, yum. That was good. That was a blowout. All right. What are you going to colonize with this little guy here?
I'm going down to colonize Bithia 3 is Bithia what I'm 3. Colonizing.
Got you.
You guys go...
An alien empire has established communications.
Uh-oh. Okay, hang on. After translating their language, we have established communication with the Abba Annihilators. The diplomatic channels are now open, and all hostilities have been terminated. Great. We don't want hostilities. All right.
We greet you as equal, Star Travelers.
It says, quake in fear, alien scum, for your doom approaches.
No, no.
Oba Annihilators will cleanse this galaxy of every misbegotten Xeno civilization that pollutes it with their presence.
They don't like you very much, do they?
It says Earth shall burn. Should I respond, we are delighted to meet you. We pursue true. Do not stand in our way. We would learn much from each other. God bless. Okay.
He just, like, he said hello to me, and he's like, whatever. And then he's going to be like, you shall die, you puny human.
Yeah, it just said that all hostilities have been terminated, and then he says, you shall perish. Like, what? That seems a little hostile to me, don't you think? We have a different idea.
Like, oh, we're gonna stop firing on you now, but you shall die. What?
But you just said the other thing. Okay, whatever.
Hostile fleet detected.
Pause. I don't care. Let's see. I'm trying to research stuff here, man. let's see. Fusion reactor. Capacitor. Energy grid. Recent progress in AI behavioral theory allows us to designate specific combat roles to our shipboard computers, right? Further advancements in several different fields. Yeah, let's do that one. Simply for the advancement. Okay, what do we got in here? 259A. Yeah, we'll kill him. I think I'm going to send two fleets in at this guy. So
boom. There you go. If you need some help, just holler.
All right. We'll do. And unpause. Pause.
Go, my minions. Go. Destroy the enemy.
Go, my minion. Destroy. It was like, hello. Oh, I can't even think of it. It's like, protect me, squire.
Where are you going? Don't leave. You came in and said hello, angrily, and then you want to leave without paying for it. No, sir. No, sir. Oh, man.
He's like, he come out there and smacked you, and you're like, what you do? And he's like, you know, please, no, don't hurt me now.
Look at these two fleets surrounding this guy.
I know.
I need some blue lasers, too, man. That'd be good. They haven't popped up for me.
System survey complete.
Let's see, where are we going?
Bring
yeah, they're
down.
Shooting lasers at you, or you're shooting lasers at them, and they're shooting like homing rockets at you.
Yeah.
Construction complete.
Ew. Oh, now she's being cute. Okay, great. Excellent.
Ooh, I'm colonizing a planet.
Yay! Nice. About time. Let's do that.
It's gonna take 49 months. It's not bad.
Not terrible. Where are you at? See, boom. Way over there, right? Great. Let's not do that. Good.
All right, we're gonna take out some pirates. Come on, guys.
Awesome.
So they'll start terrorizing me over here. Yeah, I'm gonna have to find better propulsion systems because this takes forever.
Yep.
That would be under what, physics, right?
I'd say so.
System survey complete.
Maybe we should, wait, what? Oh, okay, never mind. Maybe we should communicate with the Balrog people over there and say, hey, you want to join our federation?
Yeah, that'd be nice.
It's like, come join us! Hostile come join us, war family! Yes!
Hostile fleet.
Oh my goodness. Are we doing hostile this again? Detected. No, they have 432 power. Oh no. If they don't bother me, then I'm gonna leave them alone.
Oh my goodness. I just, like, decimated this fleet.
I would like to decimate fleets as well.
They're like, using way outdated technologies. We've got shields and everything, and they're still there shooting with the like, muskets outside the window.
Let's see. Okay, they left. It's fine.
An alien empire has established communications.
Oh, it's the chicken peoples.
Oh my god. Okay. Real Galactic Imari League. Minions of the wise Primarch Seer Minakal.
It's the Checkabo peoples. We should friend them. We should make friends with
construction
them.
Ship under attack.
Oh my gosh. Pause. Prove ourselves through the use of technology, and whether you agree with these goals or not, we trust you will remain amicable neighbors. Sure. Great. Just lost my construction ship.
Oh no.
It's missing in action. I didn't really lose it, but
debris yeah. Analyzed.
It's unfortunate.
Well, hopefully you'll find it. Hopefully you'll find it.
Yeah. Flora is mobile to various degrees. Forests.
Situation log updated.
I wonder if we'll ever crisscross down here.
Possibly. Let's see.
Oh, I just realized that we're butted up with the Galactic complete. Empire League.
Yep.
Maybe we should contact them and say, hey, you want to join our federation? Oh, you'll have to do that now, I guess.
Yeah. Let's see.
Because you're the leader.
Do that real quick. Let's see.
Oh, I can invite them.
Okay.
I just sent them. Hopefully they'll accept. They think really highly of us, so.
Okay, well, great. I'll have to vote too. Okay. I vote yes.
The Skiller Alliance voted to invite Galactic Empire who the Federation. Yes! So apparently they accepted.
Excellent. That would help. That would definitely help.
Oh, well, I mean, it said it's not... Oh, they said no.
Dang. Oh, crap. Hangar Bay.
Oh, well. It happens.
Yeah.
Yeah, let's get fission power going, fusion reactors.
Mm-hmm.
That way we can fly a lot faster.
Yeah, that's the thing. Stop attacking myself. Oh, I attacked you. My bad. That's fine. Don't think I'll be able to take him out, but we'll see.
Do you need some help?
No, I think it's okay.
They're about evenly. Well, wait, no, you have two fleets that versus their one. Yeah, you'll be alright.
Wow, I'm destroying them.
Yeah, you
wow.
Are.
Melt City. Hot diggity. Alright.
Anomaly found.
Wow, you got somebody in Irines.
Oh yeah, I do.
Alright, coming to help. Let's see if I can upgrade this one to a shipyard of some kind.
Let's pincer him.
Yeah, it's like, come in! Pew!
Yep. This is gonna be fun.
Yeah, it takes so much to upgrade a starport. That's so crazy.
I know. It's a lot. Like 750, isn't it?
It's 300 to the first one.
Oh, yeah. Wait, you're talking about a what now?
I want to upgrade to the starport.
Oh, okay. Maybe I start with an upgraded version because my next one's 750.
And then if you start with an upgraded, jeez. Lucky you.
Yeah.
Because I'm over here at Trambodon trying to upgrade its station so that way I could literally keep my fleet right there to, like, assist you.
Yeah, to deal with, yeah. I'm here.
Yeah, it's going to take me a while. 262 days. You'll probably take care of them and dispatch them before I can.
Yeah, I think we're okay.
Okay. I'll get these guys back then.
Where's the rest of them? Come on. Crap. Yeah. They didn't all show up at once. That's great.
So you have them in waves. That works.
No, I mean like mine didn't show up all at once. Second fleet is still taking its time. Hurry up, dude. Great. Missing in action. Wonderful. Yeah.
Oh, no.
Now they're coming here. Okay. Crap.
Evading hostile fleet.
Too bad we can't put like a warp gate between my hometown and your hometown, so that way.
Yeah, I know. That would be lovely, wouldn't it? Next door and destroy their base? Where's their base?
I don't know.
I think these guys are more powerful than I am. Yep, I'm losing all my stuff. Wow.
341. I'm
That's
coming.
Debris garbage. Analyzed. That is garbage.
Evading hostile fleet.
Oh, get out of my system, fool.
Get out of my system, fool!
I'm sick of your face.
Be there in 280-something days.
Okay. I should still be alive by then.
I need to start working on a second. It's just a matter of minerals. I have everything else. I just need minerals.
Yeah, I know. Same.
I am now have the proud owner of it. Well, I don't own it, but I can build it. A alien tourist colony.
Oh, excellent. Thank you.
Did you get rid of them?
They're just going all over the place.
I don't see them anymore. Where did they go?
Hang on. I don't know. They went off to the left somewhere. Great.
Oh. Okay. How do you increase your influence? Just getting bigger, more and more territory?
See. Monthly gain from effects. The gain rate remains fairly constant throughout the
situation
game.
Situation log updated.
There's a policy. Hang on. Let's see. The gain rate remains fairly constant throughout the game, but can be increased by 1. Winning the support of factions in our empire. 2. Declaring other empires your rivals.
Okay.
Other effects would just be like specific things from tooltips as far as like research or policies and stuff like that. Yeah, happy factions, yes, and rivals. So as long as the happiness stays up, then that will continue to be, that will continue to increase the generation. So,
right.
The more happy your people are. All right, so I need to get something from here. Let's see, what is this? That could be good. Starbase influence cost reduced by 10%.
Need to make my people happy.
The effect on increased tradition cost caused by number of colonies is reduced by 20%. Okay.
System survey complete.
No more hostiles, sir. Looks like not. It's good. What's this?
Research complete. Ships upgraded.
Defense armor damage. Ground defense plan.
Research okay. Complete.
Gene clinic, top blockers. Yes, I need that. Let's see. Speed, no. That's a follow.
Nice.
Soulshot, thanks for the follow, man. I appreciate you. Welcome to the Lunarian Empire. Enjoy your stay, sir. Enjoy your stay. Hope you like having as much fun as we like having fun. We like having as much as humanly possible.
Oh, my goodness. Oh, yes. Welcome to the family. Hope you have as much fun here as we like having fun. We like having as much fun as physically possible.
Physically. That's right. I always say humanly every time. I practiced it yesterday. It was like, oh, man. Said it wrong every time. Oh, man, that's fun.
Physically and mentally possible. There you go.
Physically and mentally and humanly.
Construction.
And completed. Inhumanly.
Every which way humanly, every which way possible. There you go.
Okay. Crap. There's just so many. Let's see.
There's just so many places. I don't know which way to go.
It branches off pretty crazy. So, all these little nodes, man.
Hostile who's up here? Detected.
Oh, yeah, it's the old node. Above you.
Evading hostile fleet.
Oh, my God. This part's used to be. Start running the research.
Go get him, my fleet. Let's go.
Yep.
They are special back, but no longer shall they hold us captive.
Indeed.
Let's go.
No, they scuttered my shine ship away.
And they're like, uh-oh, nope, we're out of here. Where are they going?
System survey complete.
They're trying to go to Kasora. Oh, I got them before they left the system.
Did you? Oh, awesome. Yeah. Awesome.
I'm protecting my friends.
Yes. Thank you.
You're welcome. Oh my goodness, just wipe them out. Let's just end it. Surrender something.
System survey complete.
They're dead. They're dead.
Yep. Aw, I didn't get a piece of the pie.
Oh, hey, I can actually use your, that's awesome. I can use your starport.
Can you?
Yeah, I'm preparing my ships from your starport.
Really?
Yeah.
How about that? Okay.
Construction complete.
Yeah, they're going to Sol Station to repair.
Wow.
That's awesome.
Excellent. Well, Federation benefits, man.
I guess so.
Wow, it's taken a hot minute to get to level 5.
Evading hostile fleet.
What? Where?
Where, bro?
Oh my God.
You're being attacked again?
It's a 72. It's a 72 harassing this little area. Come on now. It's so dumb. It is so dumb. Get over here. Not you, me. Hang on. Little fleet of 191. Get over here and wipe these guys out. That's dumb. I refuse to be harassed like that. Little tiny bully.
That's basically what they are. They're just come over there. Hi.
Yeah. This is a pirate base over here? Yeah, pirate station. Oh, wow. Let me send these guys over here, too. Merge the fleets, please.
Alright, so I'm starting to feel like I'm about to get attacked, so I'm gonna withdraw my my fleet back to home base.
Okay.
You seem like you're okay for now, so.
Yeah, I should be.
Come on, guys. 10 more months. 9 more months and we can get fusion reactors. Oh, my goodness.
Indeed. Indeed.
Oh, 1 more month and we can get hull plating.
Oh, for just more defenses, right?
Mm-hmm.
Excellent.
I'm going to go through and update all my ships that way. Let's see.
Construction complete.
Yay, my colony established.
Awesome.
Ooh, I can get robot workers. Look at that.
Yep.
Ooh, ion thrusters. It's already halfway complete. I'm going to take it.
Mm-hmm. That's a very good one. Things simply need to happen quicker. Yes?
Mm-hmm. And that's kind of cool, though, because, like, if you go through your ship here, like your fleet, and you say, hey,
anomaly found.
Like, reinforce this fleet with however many it's supposed to have, they automatically take off and try to rejoin the fleet.
Right, yeah.
I didn't know that. That's awesome.
Mm-hmm.
Construction complete.
Okay. All right, I'm going to build myself another colony ship.
Excellent.
Oh wait, no, I need to get my food back on.
Situation log updated.
Yeah. I'm working on my third. You gotta build this outpost first.
Yeah, my food resources were at 300 and something. Now they're at negative zero, basically.
Oh wow.
But you said that your food goes down like quickly until you establish the colony anyway.
Your energy, like your energy generation, will go down.
Hostile. No, my food's engaged.
Oh.
My energy generation is like still on the up and up. It's still like plus 18.
Well, like do you have a colony ship out right now?
No, actually they colonized Bitha.
Okay, so if a colony ship is out and about, then your energy generation will go down significantly while it's out.
Right.
So that's what I was referring to earlier.
No, it's my food that I'm trying to figure out how to do.
That needs to be improved from your planets. Like, if you click on your planets and go to the surface,
right.
Try to see if you can focus some food generation buildings.
Right.
And, of course, make sure it's being worked.
Of course.
Oh, the pirate base is gone.
Oh, no.
It's gone. Ooh, boy. It feels good.
Anomaly found.
All right. Now I can build an outpost here safely.
System survey complete.
I still have that juggernaut, the dreadnought up there. I'm so scared to send up a fleet up there and be like, hi!
Yeah, I know. It could happen that way.
Or I could go up there and be like, oh, by the way, this dreadnought has been abandoned for years. The automation systems have been corrupted. Would you like to incorporate it into your fleet?
Yeah. All of a sudden, we turn hostile to every single person on the map. Uh-oh, I locked up.
The dreadnought's going to be... Yes.
There we go. I'm going to save the game real quick, actually. Let's see.
Okay.
Save. Let's see. Okay, good.
Awesome. My fleet power is 796.
I see. That's extremely good.
I'm going to send my 796 to see if I can't take out that dreadnought.
Okay. Good luck.
Yes.
Yeah, food is eaten by pops, so if you're short, you need to reassign population to make sure food somewhere or build farms. Right. Exactly. So, just manipulate the builders and then or build additional food generation sources.
You know, this music kind of reminds me of Interstellar, just a touch.
Oh, yeah. Absolutely. The music is reminiscent of a lot of sci-fi stuff, actually.
Mm.
Classic sci-fi stuff, actually.
I got a magnetic miracle. Holy crap.
A magnetic miracle? Is that what you said?
Yeah.
What is that?
Magnetic miracle. Tile physics output plus 20%. Tile society output plus 20%. Tile engineering output plus 20%.
Holy
mother. This effect will expire in 1700 days.
Holy mother, that is great.
Situation log updated.
Alrighty. I dig it. Take full advantage.
Whatever, I'll do it. Take it in. Yeah, I'll take it in.
Indeed.
That means my physics is tripled. System almost. Survey, yeah, complete. Like I'm doing physics right now at 31%.
Hmm.
That is wow. Silly stupid.
Let's see. It's like nothing to the south here.
Well, that's good.
Yeah. Just keep it empty so I can keep on surveying systems. Need to get this guy to 5. Let's see.
Construction complete.
Yeah, you keep expanding, dude. Like you are the empire. You are the empire.
Indeed, indeed. All right, so I need to plan this out in a sec. What is this called again? Hestimer. Okay. Let's see. It's gonna be the same, right? Of course. But let's see. Alpha Centauri is closer to it, so it has to come from there. Okay. I just gotta wait for 300. It should be a little bit, but, well.
Here we go.
System
sending
survey
my naval
complete.
Fleet into the dreadnought area.
If oh gosh! Here we go.
Oh no!
Let's see. Alien vessels. Great. I can't go past that point. No, they're in the way. Crap. No, not from all the way over there. What are you doing? Stop what you're doing.
Oh my god, it's just a huge skull.
You don't know what it does.
I don't know what to do.
Oh my gosh. Automated dreadnought. I don't know what to say about it. Like, I don't see any parameters.
Military power is the estimate of combined offensive and defensive capabilities of the fleet. It's running away.
It's scared of you. Let's see.
Where are you going, Dreadnought? There's no place to run. I hope I can kill it. Come on, guys. Go, 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 go.
Good luck to you, man. Oh my god.
Oh.
Oh! Look at those blue lasers. Dude, you gotta retreat. You gotta retreat. His damage output's like 30,000.
I can't. Complete. It won't let me retreat.
Oh. Oh my god.
Yeah, I just lost my fleet.
Freaking melt. Ow. Well, now we know. Let's hope he, keeps to himself the rest of the game.
Well, I'm hoping that I didn't like bother him. And
yeah,
it's like please stay away, no, please stay away.
I had a feeling too, Brute, but I never ran into a dreadnought either. So, but makes total sense. Oh man, education, man, education.
I didn't know until I went and tried.
Indeed. Indeed. Thank you. till almost end game. Well, good. Because that tells me that they will never bother us, hopefully. Because if they did bother us throughout, then that would be completely cheap.
No, because they would just go boom, boom, boom. You're
exactly,
dead.
Exactly.
It's like, no, don't do this, please.
This game's not fun anymore. That's good to know. Oh man.
My fleet retreated. I had two ships left. Two.
Okay, gotcha. At least something came out of it, but I mean, you know.
I had 18 went in, two came out. Oh my god, these colony ships are so slow.
I know. Yep.
It's like, go colonize this place. Okay, 2 years later. Oh, we're finally here!
Special project complete. Construction complete.
And it takes like 60 months to colonize the actual place.
Yeah.
I was close, 50 months. but I got my food back up, though. Basically, excellent. What I had to do is I had to cook, like, put food plots on the surface.
Hmm. Okay. Yeah, that's usually an essential thing to do later on.
Yeah.
So you're typically pretty okay until, you know, late early game. So.
Yeah.
Gosh, these minerals are such in short supply, man. I need some more.
It's like, I got 43. I'm good. I'm doing good. I just gotta get more.
I got so much energy. I don't want to have anything to do with it.
I've got 2,400 energy.
I'm up above 3K.
Jeez.
Yep. I think I'll call it in about a half hour. That's good with
okay,
you, man.
That's totally fine with me, dude.
Alrighty.
Totally fine with me.
We've got pretty well established over here with the Federation and everything.
Yeah.
So.
Oh, yeah.
I think we're good to go.
And then we could just restart, like, anytime you want to do this again, we could just continue where we left off.
Exactly. Yeah, I would definitely prefer to until we just decide, okay, well, let's do something. Let's do a new game or like another playthrough or whatever.
I mean, because we're not really like we fought off most of the disasters, so mm-hmm. I would hate to be like, okay, we're strong, let's just start it over. But no.
Yeah, exactly. So we'll definitely keep pushing unless like there's some ridiculous thing that happens, like we get overrun.
It's like, dude, you shall live on. Here's the torch. I'm done for.
I think since we have
death ensues.
Yeah, I think since we're working together, it's going to be a lot easier. So,
especially since like doing it by yourself, I think is a lot harder.
Oh, definitely. I had to start over so many times because of that stuff. Because
you're trying to keep up your energy or your military strength, and then some people just come in, boom, boom.
Indeed.
Boom.
Yeah.
It's like, stop it. I want to keep my military, thank you!
Sign ship. Survey here, please. Tanks. Let's It's almost 5, but I can't go anywhere. Still researching projects? Wow.
That miracle is still going on. My goodness. I'm just racking in the research points. Jesus.
Yeah. Brute says, you haven't even met marauders yet. There are plenty of disasters awaiting you. I'm sure there are. We just need to make sure we're well prepared for that stuff. So. Complete.
Like the Dreadnought. I actually have I'm over here fighting a black hole as well.
Mm-hmm.
Which I'm staying away from it because one of my science ships got sucked into it.
Yeah. Oh, man. Crap. That's unfortunate. All right, well, I guess I'm going over this way. Way over that way. So lame.
Construction complete.
Excellent.
Excellent.
Give me this 4. I need this 4. Badly. Give me the things that are red. I need the red things.
I'm up to... What are you up to until your plus on your minerals?
29.
I'm at 37, so I'm... Kind
of. Yeah. I haven't been focusing it too much, I suppose, but like...
I haven't either.
Yeah. But I'm starting to find some really good systems that has, like, almost every single resource on it. This one has all of it. It has energy, mining, and all the sciences. So,
right. It's a
good place to be. I wish it was habitable, though. That would be nice.
Oh, well.
It happens.
What's up, Nanny? This is Stellaris. This is a strategy paradox game. It's kind of like Civilization in space.
It's awesome!
How you doing? Chillin'?
Research complete.
Yeah, I know Hestimer's... what is it called? Hestimer. Yeah, Hestimer's habitable. I need to wait for 300 in order to get there, so... Why? Oh, of course. It's garbage. It's total garbage.
Construction complete.
Wow. All right, fine. Tired 6 days this week of getting up at 4 a.m.? Dang. Don't sign me up for that.
Yeah, no.
Research complete.
Get me away from that stuff. Yeah, at least that is a luxury for you, man. So, that's tomorrow, which is pretty nice. So, I also have Sunday off. I actually have a lot of days off because of what I do, but I mean, if I can, like, manipulate it during the school year, I can keep a lot of days off, but it just depends on clients. Let's see.
Construction complete.
Ground thruster. Boom. Do that. Hyperdrive. Hyperdrive. Ooh.
Ooh, that sounds very nice.
Yep. Jump
drive. It's like hyperdrive. Let's go.
It sounds pretty cool. Blue lasers.
Blue lasers.
Yeah, I'm going to get blue lasers. I just want blue lasers. I got to have them, man. Like, you're melting stuff with that.
Oh, so. Yeah. I'm like, pew, dead. Pew,
it's good
dead.
Stuff. There is a policy. Pause. All right. I wish to have something good. The effect on increased tradition cost. Colonies reduced. That could be great, actually. Yeah, because it'll be much cheaper in the long run, so let's do that. Good. All right. The battles, they're not crazy looking, but they're... If you zoom in on it, it's actually pretty interesting to watch, especially if, like, there's a lot of fleets going on at the same time. Like, just watching a couple fleets go at it is really fun to watch. But if there's, like, a massive fleet battle going on, it's pretty cool to watch. We just... It's going to take a while to get to that point, but, yeah. If we get a battle in here, I'll let you see it real quick, so. Yeah, I'm sure they do, Groot. I wish I could have gotten that far before, but, nope. Not yet. One day. This also happens in real time as well, so that's the difference between this and Civ. You can pause the game to whenever you want to. Speaking of, I need to unpause. My bad. But like, yeah, it happens in real time, so you don't take turns in this. It just keeps flowing, which is pretty cool.
That is cool.
What?
I just got access to, because the Federation leadership transferred over to me, I just got access to the first fleet.
Mm-hmm. Oh. Oh. Wow, I can see it here.
Yeah.
So wait, what does this even mean? Like, you, this is
I
yours.
I control right? Where the first fleet goes now.
I see.
So, okay. But I'm leaving them there. I leave them there. I'm actually adding more to them right now.
Okay. I see. That's interesting. Okay. You can do some shenanigans with that, for real.
It's like there's just the Federation fleet. It's like, go, my minions! But like, if you have an excess of mineral, like the next time you're the leader, you'd be like, hey, just bump up the number of ships in that thing and just add them to it.
Yeah.
That's basically what I did. I bumped up the number of ships from 5 to 10 and then said, retrofit the ships. So.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
All right. Let's see. Gotta do it. I gotta send these guys over there. I gotta know what that hostile fleet is so I can continue to survey. Otherwise, these science systems are just sitting around doing nothing.
Right. So 33 is the highest.
33 what?
How many ships you can have complete. In a fleet at once.
Oh, okay. That's pretty insane when you think about it.
Yeah. I mean, because my fleet power once at 33 will be at 1.4K.
Wow.
Yeah.
Alrighty then.
All right.
Special project complete. Situation log updated.
Yep, I just made a Federation ship, and it's coming to join up on your where you set the first fleet to begin with.
Excellent. Fitz, what's up, buddy? How you doing, man? Elf's in here, too. What's going on, girl? Doing okay?
Hello.
Say hello to Dragonwell. We have a guest star on here. I'm very happy to have him on for the first time.
It's-a me, Mario.
No, your name is Dragon.
Oh, Dragonwell. Hello.
Construction
yeah, we're chilling, man. This is pretty fun, pretty relaxing, actually. So
I'm enjoying myself. Having all the fun.
They're saying hello to you in Twitch. Are you paying attention?
Hello.
What is this thing? This thing has like an alien eye. Ancient mining drones.
Ooh.
Ancient destroyers. Ancient combat drones. Mining drones. Why would you even stay there? Come on. It's just crazy harassment. Ugh, it's lame.
Like, go away. I don't want to do like, anything.
If they move out of the system, that would be nice. It's just, if they stay there, I can't really do much. Alright, whatever. Have I tried killing it? Hell no. No. I refuse. Because we saw what happened earlier to my friend here. I refuse. Hold up. Wait, that's all research, isn't it? That's actually really good. Do this. Yes, absolutely.
Construction complete.
Okay, now I'm generating 42 per turn. Which is great. Energy.
42 resources?
Yeah, resources.
Minerals?
Minerals, yes.
Oh my goodness, yep. Lucky.
I'm just focusing it, like I was down to 29, I was like, this needs to amp up, it's going too slow.
Yeah, I'm at 27.
So, yep. Yeah, because one mine should only cost you 90. You can focus it down if you just zoom into the system. I don't know what to do with the science ship. Just go back to the home base. And so do you. Don't even bother with that guy. This is what you get into tonight, man. What's the plan? Nene, I like your advice, but then again, it seems bad. I'm just kidding. No, for real, like if I attack that thing, I'm dead. So. Oh, you gotta work tonight. Okay, cool. So, yeah, I'll pop by after this, man. Check some of that out later. Did you get an email from the purchase? Let me know. Okay. Oh man. Sitting too long. All right. I haven't checked this surface in a hot minute. It's fine. Okay. Alpha Centauri. You remove some of these blocks. This needs food. Boom.
Yeah, sometimes I don't like doing this because there's one place, there's a sector over here, a system over here that only has one of each, one credit and one mineral. And I'm sitting there thinking, should I even put an outpost there? But to expand the thing, you have to.
Yeah, yeah, absolutely.
And that wastes another energy credit, so.
Yeah. Fleet power should only be like, wait, what fleet are we talking about, Brew? I don't have this yet. I thought I researched that forever ago. Maybe it's still cooking. All right, let's see. We are looking low on energy. We need to get that going. Let's see.
Oh no.
Yeah, I can't have that.
Nope.
Oh, really? The mining drones only have that much? I hope you're right. I might just send one ship over there just to see.
It's like pew pew pew.
Exactly. Climb, no. All right, Nini, you have a good day, man. Or a good night.
Bye.
Sleep well. I think Nini joined when I started playing Brigandine on Twitch, I'm pretty sure. Yeah, it definitely was Brigandine. I need to get some food to me after a bit, man.
Mm-hmm.
You getting hungry? Hi, Paris. Come here.
Meow.
Paris, sick 'em. Destroy the Federation.
Destroy the Federation.
You can see their power just master. Really?
Construction complete.
Oh, 915 was the power. Okay. It's not terrible,
ships upgraded.
But we definitely need some more forces for that, so.
Construction complete.
I'm building a visitor center on Skeldaria.
A visitor center?
Mm-hmm.
What does that do?
The visitor center... it... gives me 2 credit energies.
Okay.
This is what it produces. It produces 2 credit energies and 2 unity.
Oh, unity's great, dude.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Alien migration attraction plus 50% and makes the planet more habitable by 5%.
That's huge. That's amazing.
Okay, I'm going to have to build a science ship
mm-hmm.
for just to do debris fields for the fighting we've done. You know, just keep like a science ship and a construction ship near home so that way if anything happens.
Yeah. Excellent. All right. I've got 2 science ships, assisting research now, so it should be really quick.
Oh, you can actually assist research that way? That, I didn't know that.
Yeah, like if you have the tech unlocked, you can click a science ship and then zoom into your one of your colonies.
Mm-hmm.
And then if you right click the like Earth or the what is it? The planet. Right click the planet, then an option will say assist research. So one scientist per colony. Yep.
Yeah, that, I don't know how to do that. Okay.
If you have the tech. I'm not sure if the tech popped up for you or not, but
nah, probably not.
Evading hostile fleet.
Oh great. That's not much, 289.
Research complete.
Get out of there. Oh man. Missing in action again. Wonderful.
It's like it's just they're just lost in space.
Indeed. Lame. Alright, let's do that.
Diplomatic insults. Okay.
Construction complete.
Oh, the Obaha Annihilators are mad at me.
Strange.
Because I'm trying to, like, I'm touching their
borders, right?
Yeah, the borders. Yeah.
Doesn't look like it.
Well, I will be here in just a second.
Oh, okay.
Where am I being attacked from? Oh, you are being attacked.
Oh, well, that's the Federation fleet. That's you that I'm seeing. Right?
I think.
It doesn't matter because you're melting them. So.
Get him, guys!
Yeah, it's a Federation fleet. Hmm.
Yeah, we're kicking their butt. What the Federation fleet and the and your station right there.
Yeah,
just taking them out.
That's
taking
good.
Taking them out. Wow.
That's really good.
That is really good.
Do you know how to repair? Yeah, of course you do, because you repaired at my station the last time. Okay.
Mm-hmm. As soon as the battle's over, I'll get these guys to repair.
Y'all gonna have a war? I hope not. If we do, then we hope for the best.
Well, what are we gonna have now?
The Brute Squad is just, yeah, being funny in chat. Let's see.
Yay! Colony has been established.
Excellent. Speaking of, I need to get on that pronto. All right. So,
get another colony going.
Yep. So it needs to come from Alpha Centauri. And then, gosh, this... How is this habitable at all? Like, this is just terrible with tile blocking. Gosh, gotta work on that one.
As soon as they merge, I will, Wait, what? What is going on? I have no idea. Anyway.
Too late, Root. Too late. It's green. Currently, I have the tech to remove them, though.
Nice.
What the heck? Is this a pirate station? What? Where did they even come from? It's like in the middle of the... Alright.
Like, where did you even come from? Oh!
You're gonna die.
Welcome to Disneyland!
Welcome to hell.
Welcome to this Disneyland.
I'm gonna call that the Magical Kingdom. I'm not sure. Why not?
Woo! Come to Space Mutt!
Oh, man. This has been fun, man. A lot of fun. I can't wait for next week.
Indeed.
Kill these guys real quick and then close up shop.
Okay.
What else do you have to complete here real quick? Anything important?
Nah, I'm just surveying, just going through the whole thing, just surveying.
Okay.
Building, surveying, building, just go as far as I can.
Gotcha. There's another...
While I'm thinking about it, I am going to close my borders to the Annihilators.
Okay. Crap. Can you take the Federation fleet down real quick and destroy that pirate base?
Sure.
See where that is?
I don't know where the pirate base is now.
On Ista is the name of the system.
Ista?
Yeah. South of where you just flew into that Federation fleet, the south.
Just the pirate station?
Complete.
Yeah. So.
It's attacking.
Awesome.
Oh, they're not even repaired. What? Go repair. Yeah, I don't want to send them. I mean, they had 152, but there's. I don't want to send them in there like half.
Yeah.
Yeah, they. I don't know. Special project. That's really weird. I told them to repair a long time ago, but apparently your base is not really close. I don't know.
Hmm.
So they're going back to Seoul to repair, so.
Okay. Excellent. I got him.
Okay. I'm sorry, I thought I repaired him earlier.
Oh, you're good,
That was messed up.
No worries. I probably should repair too, actually. And upgrade.
Yeah, don't forget to upgrade, because ships don't get retrofitted automatically.
Yeah. I typically am good about that. I think I just researched something
Research
new.
Research complete.
Right. Oh, yeah, your blue lasers.
Yeah, blue lasers, right.
Blue lasers! Oh! Yes!
Alright, let's clear.
Construction complete.
Oh, it's because of the colony ship, right? Yep. Has to be. Yep. That's fine. I can pay for that. I've got 3,600 energy, so it doesn't matter.
Yeah, I've got about the same.
Yep.
It's just I need more resources. Ah!
I know.
More minerals.
Yeah.
So basically what I'm doing is telling my construction ship, hey, go here, build all the mining you can.
Yeah, I'll leave that up to you. That's really going all over there.
You know, that's really, really sad. I have my my engineering research guy like on another project, and because of all the fights we've been having, ships and I'm going upgraded through and collecting the data for, like, sending my science ship to the places where we've been fighting, yeah, I'm almost unlocked it just by doing that.
Wow, that's crazy.
Yeah, that is really crazy.
All right, he's on his way to kill.
Excellent. Also found a primitive world.
Found a what?
Primitive world.
Oh. Prepared. Sure. Boom.
Construction complete.
Excellent. Let's build a star base there. No more surprises, thank you.
Okay. Evading hostile fleet from where? There's hostiles there? Okay, we're gonna have to take forces? Let's go. We'll take care of that hostile fleet.
I just saw a pirate base on Velderom. Is that what that is?
Velderom, yeah.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, I'm about to go take it out. Be like, yeah. We can't be having none of this here.
No, sir. No, sir.
Especially since they can build their forces up, build it up large enough. They're like, okay, we're going to scout out. We're going to build up our forces. And then they go, wipe me out.
Yep.
Without being as close to my home base.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, no, it's not going to happen.
Nope.
I like it when the systems are like one or two stars, because like your science ship goes in there, goes bloop, and that's it.
Yeah.
Like, system survey complete. Wait, I just sent you there. What?
All right, no more bases. Shenanigans are over.
Goodness, we have detected some kind of utterly massive space installation drifting quietly on the edge of the Manthral system. Although preliminary scans show it to be very old, the structure has an intense power signature. Several smaller structures can be seen floating near the main installation, and all of them appear to be heavily armed. If we are to learn the true nature of this ancient relic, we will likely have to overpower its defenses through force of arms.
Wow. Okay. Sounds scary, but I have no clue what to expect from power levels.
It just ate my science ship that I sent there.
Oh, man.
Okay.
Hey, gads. I hate that. All right, that is finished. Excellent.
Debris analyzed.
Excellent.
Oh no, I've lost a scientist.
Oh, you lost the leader? Oh wow, that's bad.
He just disappears, man. What is up with that?
Yeah, it's pretty lame.
He's like, I just decided I wanted to leave. Well, I mean, I guess he's got the right, though. But
yeah. Maybe we should enforce some new policies.
Construction complete.
Seriously. Oh, goodness gracious. I've not been watching my Unity. My Unity is full.
Oh, you've been able to do a tradition? Okay.
I am about to max out diplomacy.
Nice.
Yes, I have empty ascension perk slot. Our bonuses that our empire can unlock by completing a tradition tree. Okay, click to select an ascension slot. Interstellar Dominion. The stars beckon and we allow.
In progress.
May nothing stand between us and them. Influence starbase influence cost minus 20%. Claim influence cost minus 20%. That might help me out a lot. Technological ascension. Technologies that would have been indistinguishable from magic mere generations ago are now within our reach. A new age of technology has begun. If I click this one, research speed increases by 10%. One vision. True unity is achieved only when the ultimate goals of the nation and its people are one and the same. After all, a house divided against itself cannot stand. Monthly unity plus 10%, or governing ethnic attraction plus 50%.
Wow.
Consecrating worlds. I mean, there's just a ton of them. Just a ton of them. But the ones that I have available to are, like, if you want me to, I'll just name them. If you want me to read them in depth, I will, but.
Oh, you can just name them, that's fine.
One vision, consecrating worlds, master of nature, imperial prerogative, executive vigor.
Vigor, yeah.
Yeah, vigor. Transcendent learning and shared destiny.
Wow.
I think I might do Interstellar Dominion because that way I can spread out quickly.
Yeah. That'll do well.
See, that's the thing, though. Do I want to spread out? There's a negative to that, though, because if I spread out too quickly,
yeah,
I'll wind up putting myself in a deficit. So, sure.
Yeah. I mean, like, since we are working together, we can spread out. Like, we can, like, say it's as one.
Right.
But, like, yeah. So don't feel like you have to do that, I suppose.
Yeah.
It seems pretty safe, looks like, to go to the left side, though, if you want to make your way that way. Because okay, there's, so like, nobody down here in the southern part.
Yeah, I'm gonna get the Interstellar Dominion. But yeah, I'm going down the left, because you can't go that way.
Yeah. Which is fine. I'm totally cool with that. It's a nice separation for, you know, us to have equal land or space.
Yeah.
Land.
So, oh my goodness, the fact that I can build, like, normally it takes, what, 100 mineral and 75 influence?
Mm-hmm.
I only need 60 influence now.
Wow. That's fantastic.
That is stupid.
Yep.
That is so stupid.
How do we build a shipyard for...
Shipyard
for your other colonies. So I only have a shipyard for Seoul.
Oh, that's a good question. I don't know.
Because that would help out with
construction
positioning.
Construction complete.
That is very, very true. I can look. Let's see. You should automatically have a spaceport.
No, like the spaceport's there. The shipyard is different.
Oh, you want the shipyard? Yeah. What you'll have to do is you'll have to go into the starbase section of this station, and you have to upgrade it from a station to a starport. You're talking about for like a place where all your fleet can go to repair and stuff, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, you have to upgrade your stations to a starport and then add the module for it.
Okay. Well, here's the thing though, because like if I go to shipyard, there's a starbase here, right?
Mm-hmm.
And I can upgrade to a starport from the starbase here, but like that's just for Seoul. Like what I'm wondering is like how to find it for Alpha Centauri, for example.
Oh, if you go into your Alpha Centauri and then you click on, if you look at the central sun, there's the star base there. You click on the star base.
Aha.
Yeah,
here it is. Go. Oh my God. This is a much needed. Go. Do things. Right. That's bothered me for the longest time. I was like, oh, where is this at?
But yeah, it's pretty. Well, and as you know, you're going to be like, oh, put it on everything.
Yeah, indeed. All right, we all good.
Yeah. Be all right. Speaking of which, I will make a star base there just in case we need it.
Mm-hmm.
And I'll do another star base once I have the resources. Yeah, my influence only take. I only need 60 influence now to actually do the starbase, and it costs half of. I don't know how they do this, but it costs half of a credit, a energy credit to maintain.
Wow. It's nuts.
That is really, really stupid. Yeah.
Very efficient, man. I hear you. Oh boy.
Yay, colonizing now. Okay, where do you want the first fleet to go? You want it to go back down to Iza or down to Troydam? Or Trodom?
Yeah, probably. Because okay, it would be nice to get some support for the new colony.
Yep. All right. Sending him down there. Or where you want to go, Iza or Trodam? Troydang? Or Troydom? Yes, Troydom. My eyes are not working.
Pick either... Actually, pick Tatanga.
Construction complete. Tatanga?
Okay.
Because, like, I haven't occupied that yet, and pirates could spawn there.
Okay.
So. What, baby? What? You going crazy on me right now?
Construction complete.
Mm-hmm. All right, I'm going to call it here, actually.
Okay.
So let me save the game.
Save.
I think you can save as well.
Yes.
Valgus and Dragon. Save.
All right.
Great. Excellent. Well, man, this was really fun. Thank you
so
much.
I've enjoyed myself.
It was a pleasure having you on for the first time, and I look forward to next week if you're still down.
Oh, dude, anytime you want me to do this, like, just let me know.
Excellent. Excellent. All right, everybody. I appreciate everybody who showed up today to meet Dragon and stuff like that. If you want to support him, his channels are in the description below on YouTube, and he's also on Twitch. So hit up the YouTube, hit up the Twitch, and also hit up the Mixer as well, whatever your preference may be. And I'll see you guys tomorrow for Indie Sundays. We're coming back with Dungeon of the Endless. So if you want to tune in for that, Dragon, you're more than welcome.
Of course.
So, excellent. So, all right, my friend. I appreciate it again. I'm your host, Falco Sonari. I will see you guys tomorrow. Stay well, Lunarians. Peace out. Say goodbye, buddy.
Bye.
Later on.
Stay safe.